This state tournament flashback has been brought to you by Iowa Farm Bureau. As a leading contributor to educational programs and annual scholarships for students, Farm Bureau is proud to champion Iowa's youth through athletics, academics, and fine arts. Learn more at iowafarmbureau.com.
Today's closed captioning brought to you by Valley Bank. Valley Bank, it's a great day. More information is available at our website, bankatvalley.com.
We've always got it going on. IHSSN, wherever they play, whenever you want them on. Iowa's very best. Iowa High School Sports Network.
Always got it going on, yeah.
We've always got it going on. IHSSN.
The Class 3A State Championship game is coming up next. Keokuk and Sioux City Heelan. But let's send it off right now. Mr. Rick Wolko, Executive Director of the Iowa High School Athletic Association, and Mr. Craig Lang, the President of the Iowa Farm Bureau.
Hello, I'm Craig Lang, President of the Iowa Farm Bureau.
And I'm Rick Wolko, Executive Director of the Iowa High School Athletic Association. We'd like to welcome you to the championship round.
As a sole title sponsor of the Iowa High School Athletic Association, Farm Bureau is proud to be a part of this event because it showcases hard work, dedication, and teamwork. These are the same values our members believe in and live by every day.
Our partnership with the Iowa Farm Bureau shows their commitment to our young people, and they support our association with millions of dollars in awards, recognition programs, grants, and scholarships. They're also the presenting sponsor of the Iowa Hall of Pride. With their help, we can celebrate your efforts on the field and in the classroom.
Farm Bureau knows that strong, vibrant schools are the cornerstone of many of our communities. That's why we partner with the Athletic Association and support the Hall of Pride. We believe that by investing in our youth, we're investing in Iowa's future. So from the Iowa Farm Bureau
and the Iowa High School Athletic Association,
congratulations to all of you for your success this season, and good luck in your championship game.
Your family. Your home. Your free time. Your hopes. Your dreams. Your future. Your life. Your success, our priority. Bank Iowa.
We got a great football game coming up for you in this 3A final, Keokuk and Sioux City Heelan. For Sioux City Heelan, this is their second year in Class 3A football. They started 8 sophomores last year. They're playing for a state championship this year. Chuck, when you talk about Keokuk, it starts and stops with their quarterback, James Vandenberg.
One of the top high school quarterbacks in the country. I can't tell you how impressed I am. There he is right there with the way he throws the football. He is a big-time talent. I'm talking big time. And it's going to be fun to watch him throw that football around the field today.
He has rewritten virtually all of the single season and career Iowa marks. Season best, 46 touchdown strikes, 3,510 yards, both all-time bests, 7,482 career yards, that's an Iowa best, 90 touchdown strikes, that is a career best as well. He is firing 70% accuracy on his passes. A sensational high school quarterback, and that's who we will see today. Keokuk will kick off. Sioux City Heelan deep to receive.
Look out!
Oh my heavens, we got some running room for Sean Keene. Oh my goodness, up across the 40-yard line. First and 10, Bishop Heelan.
That's a big play early in this football game because Heelan's best defense is going to be their offense. I mean, as long as they keep the football, Vandenberg's over on the sidelines, and here Keene takes it.
Okay, got an update.
Gets a great little seam, and then simply turns it up. That's some great blocking, and hey, that's a great start to this game for the Crusaders.
He about ran this back to Woodbury County.
Cornell Rice with that game, getting a touchdown saving tackle.
We will send it down to Travis here in just a moment. He has an injury date update for us concerning Bishop Heelan, Brandon Wager, and we've had some other injuries, Buckley, for Sioux City Heelan, so we'll get an update on those as well. We are going deep, opening play, incomplete, intended receiver Sean Keene, but let's send it down to the sidelines right now with Travis Morgan. Travis?
Well, guys, Brandon Wager ran for over 2,200 yards this year. Outstanding season for him. He got banged up the last game. I asked him before the game how you feel. He gave me the thumbs up. He's very good downhill. Laterally is not so good right now. Buckley Wright is going to try to go both ways. He also banged up his knee. So, fellas, both guys going to try to grit it out here early and see what happens.
Buckley Wright, one of the offensive guards for Bishop Heelan. Second down and 10, stacked backfield for Bishop Heelan. Up the middle, a pickup of 6, maybe 7 yards for the Crusaders. Let's take a look at the offensive starting lineups brought to you by Farm Bureau. From Bishop Heelan, 10-1. Of course, the quarterback, Zach McCabe. And there's Brandon Wager, 2,000-yard rusher, 31 touchdowns on the season. The tight end, Joel McCabe, 17 yards per catch. And there they are up front, Geary Wright, Nelson, Skibinski, and Bouquet. Those are the offensive starting lineups for Sioux City Bishop Heelan. We're going to have a first down.
They're going to ride Wager for all he's worth. And we don't know how long he's going to go, but he's looked pretty good early.
Here's the defense for Keokuk. Starting lineups brought to you by Farm Bureau. Bell and White up front. Neuendorf, the three down defensive linemen. Five linebackers, Kelly, Lockwood, Isaacs, Barnes, and Hopkins. Three in the secondary, Granera, Hurt, and Johnson for the Chiefs. Right up the middle we go. Even though he's hit at the line of scrimmage, a pickup of 2, maybe 3 yards.
Pretty good start here by Sioux City Heelan. Good kickoff return and really got a good start to this game.
They suck as much clock as you can.
I like the first call of the game. They try to go deep.
I like that too.
Set the tone, show their guys that they came here to win.
And they got a nice little play there because the linebacker was covering the back out of the backfield, but Hopkins just made a nice play.
Power eye formation for the Crusaders.
Fumble.
Fumble on the play, and it's going to be scooped up by the quarterback, Zach McCabe, 6'5 sophomore. Again, for Sioux City, Bishop Heelan, they started 8 sophomores last year. This is their second year in Class 3A, and they're playing for a state championship. And they've got a lot of youngsters, a lot of juniors in that starting lineup. And again, their quarterback, number 7, Zach McCabe, a sophomore.
On the fumble there, we just saw, he got the ball pinned on Cavillo's hip, the fullback, and simply dropped the ball. Not enough separation between the fake and the quarterback trying to carry out the fake with the football.
Third down and 10 for the Crusaders. Back to pass. Nice block. Steps up, fires. That's going to be a first down. The pass complete to Sean Keene. Head coach Roger Jansen coaching at his alma mater at Sioux City Bishop Heelan. Offensive coordinator is Bill Haas, and that's going to be a first down for the Crusaders.
If you watch this play all happened because of that block there by Wager. Gives him time. Get that pass off. Good job by the running back on that block.
I like how McCabe rolled out there to buy himself some time.
Yep.
Because that's how that play worked. He simply gave Keene enough time to find an open spot and got on the football.
And notice he wasn't looking to run. He was still looking downfield, looking for an open receiver.
First and 10 at the 32. One man in the backfield, Wager. There's nothing there. That's good defense by the Chiefs. Cutting his way in and making the stop, Brett Kelly, linebacker.
Even though they make the tackle here, watch how spread out Keokuk is defensively. Look at that. They had him all over the place. If he's able to break through here, there's a lot of green artificial turf to run on. Look for that play again. They're going to try that again.
Cole Lockwood also in on the stop for Keokuk. Second down and 12 at the 34. Crusaders opening drive. Back to pass. Screen tip, set tip. Up. It's tipped, but the pass is going to be caught. And now we got some running room, courtesy of some stiff arms. But oh my heavens, what a hit by James Hurt on this near sideline.
Would you say his name is appropriate on that play?
Oh, my goodness.
He's bringing the hurt on that one.
Exactly.
Huh?
But watch the ball tipped here at the line of scrimmage. They try to just run the little screen pass. The ball is tipped, but there's enough on it to still get it out there. And then the big hit at the end of the play.
James Hurt laying a lick. That young man, very smart in the classroom as well. A 4.0 GPA.
And a great receiver.
That's right. Great receiver as well. Third down and six at the 28-yard line. Stacked backfield now. Power eye formation for the Crusaders. McCabe under center. Wagner on the carry. There's just nothing there. Absolutely nothing going. In on the stop, Paul Money, I believe, big old number 55 for the Chiefs.
And he was the man who tipped the ball on the screen pass. But Money, 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 man, that guy can play. He had a great semifinal game. And I'll tell you what, he can run like a deer. Money is just, he impressed me so much with his speed. And he's kind of a big guy, but great speed out of Money.
You take a look at the offensive line for Sioux City. 215, 205, 210, 210, and 225 up front. And the Keokuk Chiefs can match that. 225, 200, 270. Those are their guys up front. And
uh-oh,
the pass is going to be picked off, and this is going to be trouble. James Hurt's got plenty of daylight at the 40, at the 30. He's got one man to beat. Cuts it back inside, still on his feet, to the 10, to the 5, down to the 3. First and goal to go. Coming up for the Chiefs, the turnover. First one in the game goes against Sioux City Bishop Heelan. All the way downfield goes Hurt. First and goal to go for the Chiefs.
Here you see the problem with throwing those long passes to the sideline. Gives that defender plenty of time to step in front of it. And Hurt takes advantage of it there. And that's a sophomore quarterback not making the best throw in the read earlier in this game. Hopefully he'll get his feet underneath him as we move along in this game.
Hit right as he threw it where he couldn't step up fully. And that ball fluttered a little bit. Hurt jumped the receiver. And how about the hustle by Heelan at the end of this play? There were four guys back there trying to make the tackle.
Touchdown.
Cole Lockwood.
Cole Lockwood on the carry, and that'll be a touchdown.
What a turn of events here. Heelan making a great drive to start the game. They turn the ball over with the pick, and one play later, Keokuk's on the board and in control.
And James Hurt, we usually talk about him as the leading receiver for Keokuk with over 1,200 yards. He's made two big plays on defense already.
That's exactly correct. Logan Granera in to kick the extra point. 69 out of 75 extra points on the season. 6:47 to go here in the opening quarter. The snap, it's down, blocked, I believe. Oh, look at that. The special teams of Bishop Heelan responding. Getting his hands on that one. Josh
Bousquet,
thank you, for Bishop Heelan. We'll be right back. Take a look at the block again on this extra point attempt.
There's Bousquet right there coming through, gets his hands up. Yep, right there.
Josh Bousquet with the block, so 6-0 Chiefs with the lead on the turnover.
No excuse for inside penetration. I can see it coming off the end, but there's no excuse for letting somebody inside the end get through there.
This will be the second possession now for Bishop Heelan. Head coach Roger Jansen has been at his alma mater for 26 years. Ninth year as the head coach. Jason Campbell for the Keokuk Chiefs. Sixth season at the helm there at Keokuk High School. That goes through the end zone. First and 10 at the 20 now for Bishop Heelan.
Much better kickoff that time by Granera. Booted that one about 7 yards deep. They give it the big return the first time. That time, no return. What's that, about 23-yard change in field position?
I would agree with that. Kickoff? Yeah. 6:47 to go here in the opening quarter. Chiefs with the lead, 6-0.
Wager still in there in the backfield.
Zach McCabe, 19 touchdown passes on the season, surveying his offense. And they'll try to swing it around. A little bit of running room, and that's going to be a pickup of 3, maybe 4 yards.
Another tackle by Hurt there.
On the carry, Brandon Wager. Let's send it down to the sidelines. Travis Morgan is down there, courtesy of Farm Bureau.
Well, guys, we've been talking about this all morning. The Southwest side is 5-0 in these state championships. I talked to Roger Jansen, the Heelan head coach, before the game. He said, well, hey, that's just the luck of the draw. We're going to go ahead and try to change that. But right now, 6-0 Chiefs right off the bat.
Power eye formation for Bishop Heelan. The give is going to be to the fullback, and not much there for Chris Cavillo. A big pileup of Chiefs drives him back in on the stop. Paul Money, along with Chris Hopkins.
And Cole Lockwood, which is interesting because Cavillo and Lockwood are virtually the same player for each team.
Take a look at the road to this Class 3A final. Number 4, Keokuk, defeating Marion 37-25. 42-7. And then South Tamaconnet County, 28-14. Sioux City Heelan, 45-7, 21-17, 26-21 as they march to this 3A state championship. In that opening round game against Carroll, Bishop Heelan, the defense and the special teams accounted for 21 points. Another interception for Keokuk. Cole Lockwood with this one. He races to the sidelines, out of bounds at the 10. Oh, my heavens. Two possessions, two interceptions, first and goal to go now for Keokuk inside the 10-yard line.
Not that Keokuk needs a whole lot of help in this game, but how about their starting field position? The yep. 2 and the 10.
See that linebacker just pop right in front of that slant route.
Nice block right
just,
there.
Just didn't see him.
Trying
he threw
to
into
hit
big
Keen.
Time coverage. Big time coverage there. They weren't going to complete that pass in
trying
a,
to hit Sean
100
Keen.
Years.
That's a good catch. It's tough to make that catch as a linebacker.
Look out.
Side route, the bubble screen, touchdown. James Hurts. Boy, we've called his name quite a bit. Two turnovers, and on the very next play, Keokuk has scored both times.
Just want to give you one more stat real quick here, Mark. Time of possession for Keokuk right now, 6 seconds. Because it's taken them 3 seconds twice to score.
That's the first pass of the game for James Vandenberg. And in case you are counting, that's his 91st career touchdown pass.
Going for two. Spread them out. Look at that. Shovel pass.
Not yet.
Hey! Nice effort.
Sensational effort by Cornell Rice. Good call, Chuck, on the shuttle pass. Vandenberg rolling out. Take a look at the effort. Hit once, hit twice, still turning, still keeps the feet moving. 14-0 Keokuk. We'll be right back in a moment on the Iowa High School Sports Network.
Casey's, it's all good. Casey's, it's all good. Casey's Pizza is loaded with all your favorite toppings piled real high. All month, get any large made-from-scratch specialty pizza for only $11.99. And sign up now to win a seat at the 2008 World Series of Poker, presented by Milwaukee's Best Light.
Casey's General Store. Casey's, it's all good.
This land belongs to all of us.
It's home to you and me.
At MidAmerican, we're committed to renewable energy. That's why right here in the Midwest, we've built one of the world's largest networks of wind turbines.
We need clean energy today.
We care about the environment and you, and will continue to do so.
For a better environment tomorrow.
Obsessively, relentlessly,
Mid-American Energy.
It's one of the greatest rivalries in college sports. Series. Game on.
5:18 to go. There's a good shot of James Vandenberg there. Now,
right here, check out the wristband.
We got a Tiger Hawk on that wristband?
We do have a Tiger Hawk on that wristband. On the inside, got the brand on the outside, but on the inside, there is a Tiger Hawk logo.
He's getting recruited by a lot of schools. He's been offered a scholarship by Nebraska. If there's any doubt where he wants to go, that wristband might.
There wasn't Herbie Husker on there, I noticed.
Got a little Tiger Hawk on that wristband. James Vandenberg, 3.95 student, active in Big Brothers and Big Sisters. And he is a fantastic quarterback at the high school level. Take a look at possession time. Sioux City Heelan, they've controlled the clock, but they are down two touchdowns, courtesy of two turnovers.
Can we classify that as a misleading stat?
Very much so. Very much so. Right back to the air.
Back to the air.
You know what? Completion or incompletion, I don't mind that call. Zach McCabe is going to have to perform here to get Bishop Heelan back into this game. Let him throw the ball.
And if you notice, that route's a little bit different. They're not asking him to throw it across the middle. They want to throw it to the sideline where if he does miss, it's an incompletion. They're just trying to get some confidence in their young quarterback.
And Zach McCabe is a 1,500-yard passer. He's thrown for 19 touchdowns this year.
Keokuk coach is up in the box here with us.
Keokuk defense, very good. He's given up only 15 points per game, and now we got a quick timeout called by Bishop Heelan, I believe.
I disagree with you. I hand the ball off there because I'm going to let him run some plays.
Calm down a little bit?
Yeah, I mean, he's thrown two picks in his last two passes. I'm not going to have to throw it again. Slow down. Slow down, son. Hand the ball off.
I want to thank our sponsors going into this Class 3A state championship game, U.S. Cellular, Coca-Cola Classic. We want to thank them as well. And we need to thank Hy-Vee, your employee-owned Hy-Vee food store. And by the Iowa Department of Human Resources, teen pregnancy, it's for real.
Does anybody else like going to Hy-Vee as much as me?
Second down and 10. You know the new Hy-Vee? You know the new Hy-Vee in Newton?
I have not been there.
They have one of my favorite signs I've ever read in my life. It says Grand Buffet. Two wonderful words put together.
Have you ever met a buffet that wasn't grand?
No.
I knew that one was coming.
Second down and 10 at the 20. You can listen online or watch the games live on the internet. Go to www.ihssn.com. The reverse with some room. Keen skips out of one tackle. Finds some running room to the sidelines. A pickup of about 7. It'll be third down and 3. That was a big tackle on that far sideline for the Keokuk Chiefs.
He showed some good moves there. He almost got caught for about a 6-7-8-yard loss, able to shake that tackle and pick up some yards.
Here it is on the replay. Now watch this. We're going to have one missed tackle. There's two missed tackle. He's going for the trifecta. Just can't quite get out of there. But
no, Heelan's moving the ball.
If it takes
okay
three
so
men to tackle him, that's a pretty good offensive play.
Logan Granera with the big stop there for the Chiefs. Third down and 3 at the 27. Short of the first down. On the carry, Weger, and it's just not there for Bishop Heelan. So the Crusaders will punt this one away to the Chiefs.
I was hoping they'd get a stop so we could see Vandenberg throw the football. He's only thrown it one time, except for the two-point pass. But the Keokuk defense has really come out smoking. They are bringing it right now.
Back deep to receive.
Look
James
out.
Hurt. This is going to be a fake. I like that call because it's working. Up to the 40. Now we got flags all over the place. We got 1, 2, 3 flags all over the place.
I was trying to throw one.
You know, that I don't think that was a called fake. He just thought it was going to get blocked. He pulled it down and tried to make something happen, which he did.
So the immediately happens?
The problem is the linemen are all downfield, and it's going to come back. But
Nate Berger on the reception for Bishop Heelan, and that is indeed coming back.
But I'm sure Coach Jansen would much rather have
this than a blocked punt. How many guys we got downfield? One, two over there. There's an army of guys downfield because they don't know. It's all behind them. You can't see.
Yeah, you know what? You're exactly right. That punt in danger of being blocked.
Yeah, he pulled it down.
And they'd much rather have that than a blocked punt and another easy score. So that's a penalty you don't mind as a coach.
No.
Pretty good job by your punter saving 7 points.
I'll tell you, though, you got to show up your blocking now, though. My goodness.
If I'm Keokuk, I come right back after it.
I could see that. Or I could also see setting up a turn because they think you're going to go after him.
They got eight guys front and center. And there's the kick. It's
going to
go out of bounds at about the 45-yard line. It'll be first and 10 Chiefs when we return, and they're up 14-0. We'll be right back. .347 to go here in the first quarter. Keokuk up on top, 14-0. And this will be the Chiefs' first, I guess, full possession, if you will. The others came off turnovers. Going to give up the middle. Not a lot there for Cornell Rice. Let's take a look at the Keokuk Chief offense, brought to you by Farm Bureau. Again, James Vandenberg, very talented quarterback. 91 touchdown passes on the year. Cornell Rice at running back. Cole Lockwood at tight end. Your wide receivers, Granera, Hurt, and Galbraith up front. Neuenberg, White, Nash, Isaacs, and Elder. Mike Neuendorf, I'm sorry. Neuendorf, 6'2", 270-pound senior. One of the tackles for the Chiefs. Second down and 10. Vandenberg back to pass. Intercepted. What's good for the goose, good for the gander. First and 10. Sioux City Heelan at the 42-yard line of the Chiefs. The pass intercepted by Jordan Lester.
That's a big play for Heelan. They needed something.
Huge.
Something to get going.
I'm thinking they're going down 21-0 here, but they came back and made a play.
This is very similar to the interception that Keokuk had, throwing that slant route. Linebacker steps right in front of it for the interception.
They worked on that play a lot in pregame where it's just a double slant. They got the wider guy in and the tight guy. And that time he kind of threw right in between the both of them. It was a bad pass by Vandenberg. Over 350 attempts this year. That's just his fifth pick in the season.
91 touchdown passes, only 5 interceptions. That's amazing. All the way downfield we go. We're going for a home run in and out of the hands of Sean Keen. That was a nice football thrown by Zach McCabe.
See, a lot of teams after a big turnover like that, they go right for the jugular and throw something deep, and that's exactly what Heelan tried to do here and almost pulled it off.
Hayden
good
Fry
pass
made
there.
A living doing that. Right in his hands. What a great throw by McCabe.
About,
look at his pass.
Exactly.
He can't throw any better than that.
He's had a couple mistakes early, but that was a pretty good ball right
there. That was a good ball. 3:02 remaining here, first quarter.
That was a get back in the game play.
Second down and 10. McCabe back to pass. Looking deep again. And again, we've got a step on the defender. The pass is into the end zone. What's going to happen? Both players had control of the ball in that corner. They're going to call it incomplete. The pass intended for Chase Weaver. And somehow coming down with it after it was all said and done, James Hurt.
Let's watch his feet, because I think that's the key thing. Hurt does not have this pass, but then takes it away. They both have it. Boy, I don't know. That's close, because his feet are in bounds.
It's like a Willie
Where
Mays.
Does he get possession?
It's like a Willie Mays style catch.
That's,
over
a, that's a good call. A Willie Mays catch. My goodness. Third down and 10 at the 42. Play action. McCabe
screen,
again.
Screen
set up. There's Swagger.
Look out.
He's got some running room. Skips over one tackler, skips over another. He's got a first down.
Heelan taking advantage of Keokuk's aggressiveness on defense. Once you get that defense blitzing and coming hard, you want to slow him down with that screen.
All right, let's take a look at this on replay. And the key to a screen pass is to let the defensive line get upfield. So you're going to watch these guys get upfield for Keokuk. Now they're going to swing the ball out to Weger over here. And then he's simply going to turn it upfield, and there's going to be some room to run. And I like the hurdle. There's a nice hurdle here. Right there. Who's that? Granera trying to chop him on that. Leaps right over and picks up the first down. Nice play. Very nice play by the Crusaders.
Zach McCabe has time now to throw the football. I think the offensive line of Bishop Heelan doing a much better job. Taylor Nelson, the junior center, 6'1", 210 pounder. I had the chance to talk to Coach Roger Jansen about that young man. Taylor Nelson at center has not missed a snap in 2 years of varsity football. In 2 years, he has not missed
choice.
A snap.
by choice.
And he loves
a few blowouts where he hasn't played, but by choice, he's been there every snap.
Weger up the middle, pickup of about 7 yards.
Heelan's done a good job moving the ball so far.
Very
good. Just been shooting themselves in the foot on a couple of those interceptions, but they've moved the ball up and down the field. The stats are very misleading at this point.
We have a score update, by the way.
Drum roll, please.
I understand that there are some Morningside College alums working up in the Northern Iowa press box. NAIA playoffs, first round, Morningside College on the road. Second quarter, they have the lead over Jamestown College, 10-0. Central
College.
So let
me get that right. The Morningside Chiefs are up 10-0. The Keokuk Chiefs up 14-0.
Up 14-0.
It's a good day to be a Chief.
Power eye formation in the backfield for Bishop Heelan. Back to pass, McKay. Downfield we go, and the pass is going to be caught. Great defense, but also a very nice catch for Chase Weaver. Well, he had the defender. Defender was draped all over.
Hurt was all over him.
And if you watch Weaver here, what I like is he catches the ball in his hands. He goes up and gets it. And not let
That's
the defender get
catch.
In there.
That's good football. You can't cover it any better than that, and you can't throw it and catch any
That's
better
right.
than that.
James Hurt was right there on the defense for the Chiefs. 1:25 to go in the opening quarter. This is our final state championship game of the 2007 season.
Fade.
Sending it into the end zone. Wide open. Wide open. The catch made by Chase Weaver.
Granera guessed wrong there. He thought it was going to be a short hitch route. And Weaver was right by him.
And that was a guess. And it was wrong. Let's take a look at this again. You'll see Granera. He's a guy right here. Now watch this. Yep. He just simply jumps the pattern. And that's as easy as it gets right there.
Two good catches there by Weaver.
Mark Allen could have caught that pass.
Well, hang on, partner.
Come on, partner. You could have caught that one. I'm not asking you to do much.
Maybe. 1:15 to go opening quarter. The Chiefs leading the Crusaders. We've got the extra point attempt here. The snap, the kick. It is up and it's good. Nick Berger kicking the extra point for Bishop Heelan, 14-7. Chase Weaver, two catches, 27 yards, one touchdown on the day. We want to thank some sponsors here along the lines of the Iowa High School Sports Network. INS, Iowa Network Services, we do want to thank them. And we want to thank the Iowa Bankers Association. And Iowa Telecom. We also need to thank TMC. The This broadcast is the sole property of the Iowa High School Sports Network. Any retransmission of this broadcast, partial or in its entirety, for commercial or personal use without the expressed written consent of the Iowa High School Sports Network is strictly prohibited.
If I'm Sioux City Heelan right now, I feel pretty good about myself. Only down seven points. We made a lot of mistakes, and we're still in this ballgame.
I think momentum's on the Heelan side, even though they're down 7 points.
Look at that stat. 22 plays for Sioux City Heelan, 4 for Keokuk. And up to about the 25-yard line on the kick return, James Hurt. This is our final championship football game. We had 4 yesterday. We've had 2 here today. And we would be remiss if we didn't thank all of the camera operators, the producer, the directors, everyone working in the truck, all of the support crew that certainly, you know, we got the easy job, guys, sitting up here and talking about the games. We have the easy job. Those guys are the ones, those men and women really work hard to get these games on the air. So we do want to thank them. 14-7, Vandenberg with the football in the shotgun. Drifts back, fires to the sidelines. There's nothing there. Incomplete. Second down and 10 coming up. Let's take a look at that Sioux City Heelan defense brought to you by Farm Bureau. Wright, Geary, Bousquet, and Skibinski up front. Jake Skibinski, a 6'1 senior, 210-pounder. Take a look at the linebackers. Wegger, Lester, McCabe, and Cavillo. Very, very talented and very quick. And then in the backfield, Ben Rickard, Brandon Wegger, and Shea Hacker in that defensive secondary. They beat Carlisle 26-21. Bishop Heelan did in the semis. That defense forced 5 turnovers. They've got 1 here today. Up to the 30-yard line. The pass is caught by Logan Granera. And that'll bring up a 3rd down. And about 4. And those kind of pass plays, that's a handoff for Keokuk.
Yeah, low risk and high reward there.
3rd down and 4. Vandenberg on the season. 241, 348, 3,500. Nebraska offered him this week to go play football and be a Cornhusker. 25 seconds, first quarter. Trying to swing it out of the backfield. Going to be short of the first down. Cornell Rice on the reception. On the stop, Zach Meyer there for the Bishop Heelan defense. Well, you just kind of seal it up. Everyone flows to the football.
We're sitting over here on the Heelan side, and there's a lot of energy in the crowd and on the sideline. Looks like Heelan's getting back in this game.
That's the end of the first quarter. Sean Geary also in on the stop for Bishop Heelan. 14-7, end of the first quarter. Chiefs will be punting when we return on the Iowa High School Sports Network.
This group, come on.
It's not easy going it alone. That's why we're making it easier than ever to get a State Farm agent for car insurance. State Farm is proud to support the Iowa High School Football State Championships. Online, on the phone, or in the office, like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Right now, Keokuk leading Sioux City Heelan. Chiefs are going to be punting this one away. Logan Granera to do the punting.
Nice punt. distance-wise, bad accuracy.
Goes out of bounds. I think the Keokuk fans wanted a roughing the punter call. Back deep to receive was Ben Rickard for Bishop Heelan. No flag on the play.
That punt, by the way, six rows up in the crowd.
Souvenir for a fan.
He threw it back. We're not playing arena.
Let's take a look.
Good acting job there. I never liked when those punters flop around like that.
He did flop, but still, you can't run into the punter when his leg's extended, and they'll usually try to protect
him. Look at him. He's playing on defense. He's a tough guy. Don't need to flop around like that.
They usually try to protect punters when their legs are extended.
First and 10 at the 42-yard line. Three wide receivers in this formation for Bishop Heelan. Back to pass, sending it over to the sidelines. Pass going to be just a bit high for Chase Weaver. Good defense there by Keokuk. A couple of white jerseys around there really making things difficult for the intended receiver.
That was Granera. Obviously, he wasn't hurt when he was running to it as the punter.
That's a great secondary for the Chiefs. Granera, Johnson, Hurt, very active.
I want to ask you a question. How could you not be a great secondary practicing against Vandenberg? When ones go against ones, I mean, you're not going to get any better work in.
Well, the problem is the cornerbacks are your starting wide receivers.
Right, but you switch them off a little bit.
Second down and 10. Wegger on the carry near midfield. Third down and 4 coming up.
He certainly doesn't look like he's hurting too bad today. He's had a pretty good game so far.
2,211 yards on the season coming in. And I find it interesting that Heelan is setting up the run with the pass. You think when you've got a 2,200-yard back that you're going to run the football.
Maybe that's
they're running the ball after throwing the pass.
Maybe that was their game plan, not knowing what they're going to have with Wegger. But now the coaches are realizing he's pretty healthy.
They probably have two game plans, really.
Power eye formation in the backfield. It's trying to spin on the one tackle. That's good defense by the Chiefs. Nothing there. That'll bring up a fourth down and about one. Getting up off the bottom of the pile, Jordan White, big old number 77, 200-pounder. Up front, that's just great defense.
And the thing is, when they get him, they drive him back.
Making contact there initially. Yeah, Brett Kelly from the linebacker spot.
0 yards after contact, and that's important.
So Bishop Heelan will punt this one away.
I like this call. Play a little field position. Only down 7. Let's not get crazy and give them a short field to work with. Let's pin them down and make it go a long way.
James Hurt, deep to receive. He'll let that one sail over his head. That's going to go into the end zone. First and 10 at the 20 for the Chiefs. We do want to thank Wellmark Blue Cross and Blue Shield. You just can't beat the Blues. Also, the University of Northern Iowa. It is a pleasure to come up here and broadcast these games inside the Unidome. We do want to thank the University of Northern Iowa. And Russell Athletic Wear. We've had some Russell t-shirts that we've thrown into the crowd this entire weekend. And by Cookies, sauces, and seasonings. We do want to thank Cookies.
Watch for Vandenberg to go deep here. They've been throwing underneath. I'm thinking they're going to go up top here pretty quick.
Going to be the draw play, trying to find his way to a corner. Not much there for Cornell Rice.
We've heard a lot of Hurt on defense, but we haven't heard much from him on offense besides that short touchdown catch. I would look to see him get a couple balls thrown his way pretty quick.
You know, Cornell Rice coming into this game for Keokuk.
I like his yards per attempt.
Almost 10 yards per attempt.
But when you throw it as well as they do, you can't stuff both the run and the pass.
Kind of opens things up, doesn't it?
Yep.
Second down and 7. Out of the backfield, this is Rice. First down.
He's a nifty little runner. You saw him pick his feet up there, avoid the tackle. He's a nifty little runner, and that guy's tough now.
And he's a perfect running back for this system.
Yep.
Catch those short passes and a scat back that can make people miss in the open field. That's the perfect kind of running back you want in a spread offense like this.
Yep. Jordan Lester.
You want power. Elusiveness is what you're looking for.
Jordan Lester missing that open field tackle and tracking him down from behind was Josh Bousquet. INS quick stance here. First down, Sioux City Heelan 5. Keokuk 1.
Oh, look at this!
Nailed down to the turf. James Vandenberg took a shot. The ball pops up in the air, and it's an interception for Sioux City Heelan.
And that's going to go down as an interception for Vandenberg, but that's certainly not his fault.
Well, he's got to get rid of it.
He took
he had
shot.
Time. One, no. And then he gets hit. That's Wegger on the hit, isn't it?
Coming up with the INT.
Cole Wegger on
the hit. Jake Skibinski. Jake Skibinski had goal. I'll tell you something. As a defensive lineman, that's goal line time. I mean, you're looking at that goal line. First and 10. And they're going to try the fade route. This is going to be picked off by Keokuk at the 2-yard line. The third interception thrown by Bishop Heelan quarterback Zach McCabe in this game.
We haven't played 15 minutes yet, and that's 5 interceptions in this football game.
Trying the fade route to this near sideline.
Well, way too much air underneath it. He never gets it near the end zone.
And
that's got to be thrown in the back of the end zone.
Logan Granera had all the time in the world to wait for that one to come down. The intended receiver was Chase Weaver. Weaver, a pretty good basketball player, but even he can't get up and get that rebound. Right back out onto the field after taking that shot, James Vandenberg.
Interesting defense there by Heelan. They had 3 guys covering up Hurt.
And
the
they went out of
there.
Formation the first time. That was a running formation. We haven't seen that out of Keokuk yet today.
3 interceptions. Keokuk has thrown 2. Sioux City Heelan has thrown 3. Second down and 4 at the 8-yard line.
You run it here again. Spread them and run it. Your I formation once again.
Cole Lockwood lines up at the fullback spot.
Same play.
That's close to a first down.
Looks like he got it from up here.
Stops the clock, 8:47 remaining in the first half. Well, you gotta like the resiliency of the Chiefs. They have responded defensively when they needed to. Keokuk in the first quarter scoring twice quickly off Bishop Heelan turnovers. And they lead it 14-7. Really the only sustained drive coming from Bishop Heelan.
Well, the first 2 times Keokuk had the ball, they had to go 2 and 10 yards.
That's
so.
Right.
There you go.
We're going up top. We got a man open. That's caught. That's by midfield. Nice pitch and catch. The Logan Granera comes up underneath it. It'll be first down and 10 at the 27. Make that the 31-yard line.
56 yards.
Granera could have a big day. They were really paying a lot of attention to Hurt. He was on the near side here. And they had single coverage out there on Granera, so they could look to exploit that even more than they have already.
You like that pass there, Mr. Smart Guy?
Perfect.
Shea Hacker, the defender over there for Bishop Heelan, just lost a step on Granera.
And I tell you what, a step against Keokuk is magnified about 5 times.
That's very true.
But you knew they were going to go up top sooner or later, and he was wide open.
3 wide receivers in this set.
Nice tackle.
Not much there for Cornell Rice as he met the linebacker for Bishop Heelan, Chris Cavillo.
Cavillo and Lockwood are both fullback linebackers. One wears 2, one wears 8. But I tell you what, they are almost identical players. I mean, they do the same things and just very similar.
Let's head down to the sidelines right now. Travis Morgan is standing by. Travis.
Well, guys, I'm standing next to Mark Long, who has quite possibly the greatest mohawk I have ever seen in my life. And he just did it last night just for this game. Mark, tell us something.
Ooh,
great play.
Ooh. Pass is going to be caught by Logan Granera. And then he is drilled again by Cavillo, the linebacker, number 8 for Sioux City Heelan. We got to get back to that. We got to get back to that.
I got to see
mohawk.
That mohawk.
Can we get
awesome.
Back?
Look at the height. Look at the height on this thing. Now you did this last night.
Yeah.
Does your mom know about this?
Yeah.
And so how much hairspray does something like that take to obtain?
A lot. I don't know.
Can and a half?
No, not that much.
Not that much. You know, he's going with the reverse Travis Morgan look. High on top, nothing on the sides, fellas. Back to you.
Under 7 to play here in this first half, and flags fly, first and 10 at the 16 for Keokuk.
Hey, Travis, I got a question for you. Does your mom know? How do you hide that?
She does now.
You're not going to wear a hat like, what, Abe Lincoln? I mean, what kind of hat's going to hide that hair?
see a Mohawk like that, I feel like I'm on my way to a Ramones concert.
Good line.
First and 15 at the 21.
Travis is probably just jealous he couldn't have borrowed some of the hair that he shaved off.
Like that, the reverse Travis. March off 5 yards on the Chiefs. Takes the ball back to the 21. Vandenberg fires over to the sideline. Pass is going to be caught by Granera. Not much else there. Good response time by that Bishop Heelan defense. And that's what Coach Jansen has told his defense. You know, we keep telling those guys, if we get a lot of people to the football, good things will happen. That includes quick tackles, no gains, and turnovers.
Aren't you impressed by the way Vandenberg throws the ball on the move?
Yeah.
I mean, those passes are right on the money.
He throws a very catchable ball. Nice, oh, tight spiral. Easy to catch as a receiver.
They're going slant right here. They haven't thrown it for a while. Watch for the slant.
Second down and 14 at the 20. Vandenberg back to pass. Too high. Incomplete. Third down and 14.
Good call there by Chuck on the slant route. That's one of their bread and butter plays.
That is.
They get back to it eventually, even though they threw that interception earlier in the game.
Well, that was the touchdown pass. But that time the safety stayed home in center field in the middle, and they got the coverage from the inside on the corner, and then the safety came up, so there was really a small window to throw that. And if you're going to miss it high. You made the right choice.
Yep. Third and 14 at the 20. Third down conversions. Those were right on your screen there. Vandenberg has to hurry into the corner. What a catch! What a catch by James Hurt. How did that happen? How did he come down with that? It literally, from where we were sitting, it looked like he caught it with one hand.
Oh, that is fantastic. Now, I want to also point out, the throw here is only where his guy can catch it. Fantastic catch.
Hurt just simply wanted that ball more than the defender.
How high did he get to get that?
As a coach, that's exactly what you teach, is you go up and catch the ball at the highest point, and he certainly did that there. He's had a great game so far.
You know, the Crusader defender was there. That was just a great catch. James Hurt, 2 catches, 2 touchdowns, all in a day's work. Extra point, up and good, 21-7. Chiefs on top of the Crusaders, just under 6 minutes to play in the first half.
When hot, molten rock, ash, and gases erupt and escape from deep below the surface. It often results in a touchdown. For those who have what it takes on the inside, Russell has what it takes on the outside.
Derek, in as dry as it gets.
I was busy minding my own business when a wise guy and one of his goons burst through my door.
You that investigator I've been hearing about?
Who wants to know?
Let's just say I got a little problem I need your assistance with.
His goon produced a rack of ribs so dry they made my eyes itch. You've got yourself a problem, but you've also come to the right place. I poured on the sauce and his troubles were gone. Another day, another case solved for Speed Herring Flavor Investigator.
Cookies is the one.
Bishop Heelan and Keokuk, both in their first ever Class 3A state championship games, and the Chiefs are leading it.
We see James Hurt, who has 2 catches, both for touchdowns. We didn't talk about that last catch, and I think what really happened, and it was the strength of Hurt. We didn't talk about how strong he went up for that ball. He just, right in his hands, how strong are his hands to just snatch that ball out of the air and then stretch it out for the touchdown?
You see that last drive by Keokuk. They marched 98 yards in 9 plays. That's a great drive there, led by Vandenberg and Hurt.
The big 56-yard pass to Granero, the main chunk of it.
That really shortens up the field, doesn't it?
Oh.
The Chiefs will kick it off. Logan Granero will kick.
Nice kick.
And this one's going to go into the end zone, and Bishop Heelan will have it first and 10 at the 20. Ben Rickard catching the football into the end zone. 5:53 to go here in this second quarter. 21-7, Chiefs with the lead.
I have paid my dues, fellas, so it's okay if I'm a member of the James Vandenberg fan club.
Bank Iowa with this quick stat. Average yards on the first down. Keokuk 8. Sioux City Heelan 0.8. Boy, our stats guys, they're doing a good job today.
That's the best crew money can buy.
First and 10 at the 20.
Power eye. Haven't seen that formation a lot from Heelan.
Wager.
Look out.
Wager is out into the open across midfield. Tries to cut back, and he's going to be down at about the 33-yard line. That's a big play, ladies and gentlemen. Brandon Wager. We didn't know if he was going to be the play today or how he was going to be. He's got a bad ankle. He is banged up, nicked up, averaging 8.5 yards per carry on the season. A 2,000-yard rusher. Boy, oh, boy, he hit the
nice
seam
move.
And found some daylight, running right past Cole Lockwood there.
Tell you what, 47 yards on that run, and if he's got a bad ankle and can run like that, I don't know if I want to try to defend him with a good ankle.
Let's send it down to Travis Morgan now for a quick comment. Travis?
Well, guys, you obviously can see Brandon Wagger's a little hobbled because that's the first time this year I've ever seen anybody run him down from behind. Usually he gets out in the open field. It is six, but today, a little banged up, and they're able to catch him from behind. So pretty rare feat right there, somebody doing that.
Travis Morgan on the sidelines. Those reports brought to you by Farm Bureau. 21-7, Keokuk with the lead.
Guarnera had a pretty good angle on him, though. It wasn't a matter, you know, he measured that pretty well.
Second down and 7. Ball at the 30-yard line. McCabe under center, that power eye formation. First man through the hole, just trying to bull rush his way.
That's Cavillo, the fullback. Yeah.
Chris Cavillo, the senior, averaging about 5 yards a carry coming into this one. He'll pick up 3, maybe 4 tough yards there. Be third down and 5 at the 28.
It's really a shame we haven't seen any big plays yet in this game.
Both these teams like to grind it out.
Hey, don't go to the fridge till we call timeout, okay?
11 carries, 76 yards for Brandon. Has yet to hit pay dirt, but that may change here momentarily. 21-7. They'll give it back to him. He's got the first down, and then some.
Wow.
Down inside the 15, first down, Crusaders. How important is this drive, Jack? They just gave up a couple of big plays and a touchdown to Keokuk, but now to respond and maybe go in halftime down just 7.
Yeah, a touchdown would be huge here, and they've done a good job of answering the call. They marched it right down the field, eating up some clock, keeping the ball out of Vandenberg's hands, which is a key, as Chuck pointed out earlier in the game.
Power eye formation in the backfield. Pickup of 1, maybe 2. Again, just fighting for those tough yards. Brandon Wager. Yeah, we got this our last game here of this Class 3A state championship game. We had 4 yesterday, 2 today. Right after this, this Unidome cleans out. These guys have just about, an hour and a half to get this place ready for a Division I AA game between Southern Utah and the number one ranked Northern Iowa Panthers. How about that for a quick stat? Over 100 yards rushing for Sioux City Heelan, 16 for Keokuk.
No, even if Heelan does score here, if you leave any time on the clock for this Keokuk team, they can score quickly.
Fellas, we can't forget, Heelan is here because they beat Harlan in the playoffs. And I'm telling
right.
you beat Harlan in the playoffs.
At Harlan. Yeah.
You got a football team. They're not going to go away.
Keep in mind, this Heelan team is very young. A lot of underclassmen.
Oh, yeah.
Sophomores and juniors on this team, they should be strong again next year.
But look at their athleticism. I mean, they got a bucket full of good athletes wearing blue and yellow, blue and gold, I should say.
Wager spins out of one tackle, can't spin out of the rest. He is smothered after a loss of about 3 yards.
4 guys in the backfield.
Wow.
For Keokuk.
That's just
Do we call that the kitchen sink?
That's just a missed blocking assignment. That guy came through pretty much untouched. Thought he had a little face mask there and didn't get called.
That's Lockwood, the linebacker, isn't it? Yes, it is.
Good break for Keokuk there not to get the penalty called.
You know, Jack, you talk about the youth of this Bishop Heelan football team. They will have their entire offensive line back next year. Brandon Wager will be back next year. Their quarterback will be back next year. One of their wide receivers will be back next year. They're in good shape right now. We'll be back on the Iowa High School Sports Network. Crusaders called the timeout there to figure this out. A big third down and 10 coming up at the 15-yard line of the Chiefs. And there's some nice blocking up front. Cavillo on the carry, going to be short of the first down. Up to about the 9.
I thought they might run it there. When you saw that formation with the single back, you're almost thinking, that's a little too obvious, a passing formation. They may try to sneak a run in there, and that's exactly what they did on the counter to Cavillo.
Well, Brandon Wager is their place kicker. He's got a 36-yard field goal on the season, but it looks like right now at 4th and 6, Bishop Heelan's going to go for it. Clock approaching, 2 minutes remaining in the opening half.
I'd look for Weaver here throwing something up to him. He's had a good day receiving.
They're going power eye, though.
Wager on the carry, bounces it outside. He's going to be close to the first down. Let's see where they spot it.
He put his head down and got that first down. Boy, he's quick.
He is slow getting up.
He's hurting, but he's a gamer.
Wow, he is slow getting up.
Watch the explosion, though, at the end of this run to get the first down. Puts his head down right in his chest. Does that hurt?
It's a good seal block by Cavillo. Coming up, James Hurt on the stop for.
Doesn't get it.
Chiefs does not get it.
How about the call on 4th and 7 to run the ball? That's confidence in your running game.
Yeah, but you know what? You could make worse calls than getting the ball in Wager's hands.
Yep.
Now we've got 1:50 remaining in the half, and you mentioned it. That's like an hour for Keokuk.
They went 98 yards in just a couple minutes last time, 3 minutes last time. So
Chief defense came up on that stop when they needed it, guys.
Big play there.
They got 3 timeouts remaining, too, heading into the halftime.
Well, if Heelan punches that in and Keokuk doesn't score to finish off the half, they will have turned 3 interceptions to just a 1-touchdown game.
Look there, Keokuk's average plays per drive. They're averaging 3 plays per drive.
Keokuk going to hand the ball off. They might just be patient to run this clock a little bit.
No, they're not.
Lockwood on the carry. Timeout, Bishop Heelan.
That was a give me a little room call right there.
Hi, is there anything?
Hey, what's
I can
that
help
mean?
You?
Our goal is the best network here.
Oh, well, the best network means uninterrupted service.
That's quite a goal, right?
Yes, well, for uninterrupted service, our cell tower engineers.
They sound important.
Yes, well, they really know their areas. Many of
the engineers.
Yes. They live in the area.
They live in the area, so that's smart. Smart, so smart.
Give you uninterrupted service.
Uninterrupted.
Yeah.
I like that.
U.S. Cellular is wireless where you matter most.
Here's our graduating class.
And our salesman of the year is Brian.
I heard you're starting your own business. This calls for a real celebration.
No matter how things change, Wellmark Blue Cross and Blue Shield is there, giving you a number of ways to take charge of your health and gain peace of mind, knowing you and those you care about are protected with affordable coverage and hassle-free service. Wellmark Blue Cross and Blue Shield. The difference is blue.
There's your score, 21-7 right now, 1:44 to go in the second quarter. I formation in the backfield, first man through for the Chiefs. Pickup of just a couple.
They're just looking for a little room to get out of the end zone.
Yep, you're right. Under 1.5 to play here in this second quarter. Bishop Heelan using all of their timeouts so they can't stop the clock. Vandenberg under center.
He's short.
Short of the first down, so the Chiefs will have to punt this one away.
Boy, did they get conservative down there.
Well, and Bishop Heelan, I think that the defense now, understanding what's going on, that's a big stop for them.
A lot of times what a team will do is try to get one first down, and if they do, then kick it in the 2-minute drill. And it looked like that might have been what they're trying to do. They didn't get it. Now they're just going to try to run that clock as much as they can.
You know, again, credit the linebacking core. Cole Wegger, Jordan Lester, Chris Cavillo, Joel McCabe stepping up for Bishop Heelan there.
But once again, I go back to the statement, you are what you are. And they throw the football, and I don't care if I'm on the 7-yard line, that's who I am.
Fourth and one.
Let me take a timeout here.
And Logan Granera back to punt this one away, and Keokuk's going to take a quick timeout. Back to receive the punt is Ben Rickard. That'll stop the clock at 27 seconds. Let's take a few moments to thank some sponsors along the way here for the Iowa High School Sports Network. We do want to thank the Iowa Army National Guard, Be All You Can Be. And by IM, Iowa's Abstinence Mission. And we do want to thank Musco Lighting. We make it happen. Musco Lighting. Musco also helping us out with the telestrator here. Up in the booth. And by Pizza Ranch. Special thanks to Pizza Ranch. And coming up in September of 2008, the inaugural Pizza Ranch Kickoff Classic. A special statewide broadcast of high school football featuring two teams to kick off the 2008 high school football season. The Pizza Ranch Kickoff Classic coming up September of 2008. Mark Allen, Jack Woodford, Chuck Reed with you down on the sidelines. Travis Morgan, Class 3A championship game inside the Unidome. Keokuk leading Bishop Heelan by the score of 21-7. And now we'll have this punt from Logan Granera. There's the kick. Rickard comes up. Rickard has it kicked off his hands. That's going to be downed at about the 47-yard line. It'll be first and 10, Bishop Heelan. Covering that up for the Crusaders was Shea Hacker.
He had a chance for a good return there.
I didn't like him running up on that. That ball had a funny spin on it, and something bad looked like it was going to happen. And I'm almost like, let that ball bounce. Take it where you get it. Who knows? You might get it. The spin on that ball, you had a 50-50 shot going forward backwards. So you may get a little bit just on the bounce. And don't risk the fumble there.
So here comes Bishop Heelan. They've got plenty of time to throw the football, finding a man open on the sideline. Good patience there by Zach McCabe. Chase Weaver on the reception.
Good job getting out of bounds there by Weaver. Still 11 seconds on the clock. Maybe get one or two more plays to try to get into field goal range.
They only rushed four, and no one got near McCabe. Look at that. He's got all day to throw that. And steps up and makes a nice pass.
Second down and two. The ball at the 39-yard line.
They're only going to rush three and drop eight here.
The snap is low. Gets through McCabe's hands. He steps up, fires downfield. Couple of receivers down there. It's going to be intercepted.
Oh, watch out here. That's Hurt.
James Hurt on the interception. The clock has expired, so whatever happens here, it'll be all over. Hurt still on his feet. And
oh,
down
almost
at the 44-yard line. Oh, my heavens. 21-7, the Keokuk Chiefs leading Bishop Heelan. We are at halftime of this Class 3A game, and we have seen about everything in the first two quarters of football.
I cannot believe that Heelan, and this one's, with an asterisk, but they have thrown four interceptions in the first half and are still in this football game. Now, Hurt with a great return here. That's his second pick of the half. He just brings it out. He almost breaks this back across the field.
That would
right
been
there. If he gets, somebody fell on the back of his foot. If he gets through there, he's got some green grass.
And that would have been a backbreaker.
I'm sorry, Jack. 21-7 the score. We'll be right back in a moment.
Check this out. In the last 10 years, nearly everything has gotten more expensive. Sometimes inflation is the cause. Sometimes raw materials cost more. But through careful management and construction that takes better advantage of renewable sources of energy, MidAmerican Energy has maintained stable electric prices in Iowa for the last 10 years. And the company is committed to maintaining price stability until 2014.
Obsessively, relentlessly,
time is one of your most valuable resources in the business world. You need information and service now, not tomorrow. You're on the move, and every minute counts. You need a bank that can keep up with you. At Valley Bank, we lead with speed. Our business banking experts help take businesses to the next level every day with fast local decisions and a sense of urgency to deliver results when you need them. Let us help you reach your business's true potential, because at Valley Bank, we lead with speed.
I'll tell you something, guys, 21-7, I've never seen a football half like that.
It's a weird game. It is a weird football game.
You know, the interceptions, the big plays, both passing and running. I think time of possession, do we have that statistic here in front of us? You know, Bishop Heelan, they've had some sustained drives. They just haven't been able to score.
They've had the ball nearly 16 minutes here in the first half. Keokuk's had it only 8 minutes and 10 seconds. And Keokuk, you know, you look at the numbers, Vandenberg's been good, but they've only rushed the ball for 25 yards. This is a goofy game. I knew this was going to be a funky game because I could not get a handle on what was going to happen. And I told you before this game, we could see 50 to nothing. We could see 0-0. We could see anything happen in this game. And we have seen strange things happen.
And Bishop almost spotted Keokuk 2 touchdowns there, giving them the ball on the 2-yard right. line and the 10-yard line. And that's really the difference in the game right now.
Yeah, you take away those 2 scores, it's 7-7.
Right. First 2 interceptions by Keokuk. One, they returned it to the 2. The second one, they returned it to the 10. They were easily able to punch those in for the 14-0 lead. Crusaders responded, but then Keokuk was able to take it right back down, get that 21-7 lead. But then, down here at the other end, it was a 4th-and-10. They had to get it to the 3. The Keokuk defense steps up. Bishop Heelan got it to the 3.5, turned the ball over on downs. This has just been a crazy game so far.
Well, you just wonder how Keokuk's ahead by 2 scores.
21-7 the score right now. We're at halftime of this 3A championship game. We'll be right back on the Iowa High School Sports Network. Point lead for Keokuk, and 176 members of the All-State Cheer Squad on the field right now inside the Unidome, entertaining the crowd here at halftime. 21-7, Class 3A state championship game. Mark Allen along with Jack Whitfer, Chuck Reed, Travis Morgan down there on the sidelines. Let's head real quick here to some stats here, guys. There's a couple of interesting numbers that sort of jump out at you, and Chuck, you kind of hit the nail on the head. The passing yards and the rushing yards, big difference between the two teams. Keokuk likes to pass. Sioux City Heelan, they like to run.
This is absolutely amazing. Six turnovers in a state championship game in one half.
Take a look at the statistic below it. Interception return yards. 150 for Keokuk, 18 for Sioux City Heelan. Some teams are happy with 150 passing yards in a game. That's interception return yards that the Chiefs have put up on the board.
Well, how many does Hurt have? He picked the one off in the flat, ran close to back 100. To the two, and then ran the one back at the end of the half. He's got to have well over 100 of those 150.
So I agree.
The numbers in this game, here, this is all I have to say. I don't know what to make of it. That's all I got.
21-7, that's the score right now, Chiefs and the Crusaders. And we do want to thank all the sponsors of the Iowa High School Sports Network. Let's take a timeout. We will be right back here in a moment.
You give a little love, and it all comes back to you.
Applebee's presents another great moment in Cyclone sports. 2002, heavily favored Nebraska comes to Iowa State only to suffer a crushing defeat under the guidance of Iowa State quarterback Seneca Wallace. The Cyclones humiliate the Cornhuskers 36-14.
I'm Rick Wolko, executive director of the Iowa High School Athletic Association. Applebee's is proud to present this state championship on the Iowa High School Sports Network. Because Applebee's supports the next generation of great Iowa athletes. We'll see you after the game at Applebee's.
The people of Iowa keep in touch with each other, with the world, due mainly to the vision and leadership of Iowa Network Services. INS brings long distance, internet, digital television, and other state-of-the-art services to Iowans. What's even more amazing is as telecommunications advances, INS is leading the way to deliver them to you. So dream big, even in rural Iowa, and INS and your local independent telephone company will connect you to the world.
Catch it, kick it, drive it, watch it, hit it, win it. From the big leagues to the little leagues, sports lighting for your field, your community. Musco, we make it happen.
Around the state of Iowa on the turf of the Unidome right now, entertaining the crowd. We are settling in for the second half here of this one. 21-7, the Chiefs leading the Crusaders. And immediately following this game, number one ranked Northern Iowa is going to be playing Southern Utah. There's playoff football happening in Pella, NCAA Division III football. Central College at home this afternoon. Morningside College and St. Ambrose playing in NAIA playoff football today. And, of course, later on this afternoon, the Iowa Hawkeyes kick it off with Western Michigan, the Iowa State Cyclones at Kansas. Academic All-American Jack Whitfer up here. And he hits me every time I fail to mention the Iowa State Cyclones. So Iowa State got a great opportunity against Kansas down in Lawrence. Well, let's take a look at some of the highlights of this one. Chiefs and the Crusaders in a Class 3A championship game. Keokuk making their first appearance in a 3A state championship game. Bishop Heelan making their first appearance in a 3A state championship game. James Hurt on the interception from Zach McCabe gets it down to the 2-yard line. And just like that, Keokuk punches it in. More of the same. Cole Lockwood on the interception.
Pick number two.
He brings it down to about the 10-yard line. And then touchdown pass number 91 for his career. Vandenberg connects with Hurt. Then Vandenberg throws the INT. Coming up with it, Jordan Lester. And the fade route, great pass, great catch. Reeling it in, Chase Weaver. That's just good defense. Whoa. Vandenberg stood in there and he took a shot. Jake Skibinski coming up with the interception for Bishop Heelan. But then at the goal line, another INT. Logan Granera comes down with it. And this time a 98-yard drive capped off with a touchdown pass into the hands of James Hurts.
Great catch. Go ahead and celebrate, young man. That catch is worth celebrating.
Bishop Heelan was able to move the ball. They just could not find the end zone in that first half. Goal line interception there to close out the second quarter, coming back with a James Hurt. And we thought, Chuck, he was going to be gone.
When he almost burst through right here, I'm thinking, uh-oh.
Some of the students watching the All-State cheer team on the floor of the Unidome. 21-7. We'll be right back on the Iowa High School Sports Network.
Iowa Telecom, advanced telephone and internet services with a personal touch. Reliable connections now and well into the future. Bringing high-speed internet service to hundreds of rural Iowa towns. Believing and investing in Iowa and its people. Stay connected with Iowa Telecom.
It's one of the greatest rivalries in college sports. The Hy-Vee Cy-Hawk Series. Game on.
This group, come on.
It's not easy going it alone. That's why we're making it easier than ever to get a State Farm agent for car insurance. State Farm is proud to support the Iowa High School Football State Championships. Online, on the phone, or in the office. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
There's your halftime score in this 3A championship game. Let's send it down to the field right now. Travis Morgan is standing by with the parents of Keokuk quarterback James Vandenberg. This brought to you by Farm Bureau. Travis.
Well, guys, we're down here with Ann and Toby. And guys, it's been a heck of a week for your boy. A state championship and a big offer from a big-time Big 12 school. Let's talk about that.
It was really neat. I mean, the chance to get to play in the dome is really neat for James and the team. That's actually more exciting right now than the offer.
From Nebraska?
Yes.
Okay. Now, we've seen some things on his wrist here today. He has a Hawkeye wristband that's turned upside down. You want to shed some light on that for us, Ann?
I can tell you I wash him every week for him. You know, James really isn't even thinking about schools right now. I mean, his main focus, even when he got his offer from Nebraska, was I want to just finish my year. I want to get my team, and we want to get to the dome, and we want to finish the year good. And he said, you know, he wouldn't allow me to talk about anything this week. And I said, you know what, we'll talk about it Saturday night.
Well, and it is Saturday, so can you lean a little bit one way or the other? Maybe if he's leaning one way or the other, can you tell us kind of where he's headed?
Actually, I don't know. Nebraska was kind of his dream school. He went to camp there. He really liked the staff. And then when Gabbert committed there early, they kind of stopped recruiting him. And then Iowa's been recruiting him hard all season but hasn't offered him. Michigan State.
Hint, probably.
And then Michigan State's just come on strong in the last week. And then Missouri and Kansas was talking to him. But I don't know where he wants to go, and he'll have to make the decision. I think hopefully next week some things will develop, and then we'll have more decisions.
Well, obviously right now, all we're really worried about is a state championship, though, am I right? All right. Well, guys, thanks for shedding some light on the subject, and wish your boy the best of luck in the upcoming minutes and the upcoming months.
All right. Thank you very much.
Thanks, guys. Guys, back to you.
Hey, thank you very much for the Vandenbergs for joining up with us here on the Iowa High School Sports Network. 21-7, Chiefs on top of the Crusaders. We'll be right back in a moment.
This state tournament flashback has been brought to you by Iowa Farm Bureau. As a leading contributor to educational programs and annual scholarships for students, Farm Bureau is proud to champion Iowa's youth through athletics, academics, and fine arts. Learn more at iowafarmbureau.com.
Welcome back to the Unidome, the Class 3A state championship game. The Chiefs of Keokuk on top of the Crusaders of Sioux City Bishop Heelan 21-7. And in a goofy first half, I just don't know where to begin with this one, Jack. I mean, you think Heelan has the momentum, and yet Heelan is trailing by two scores. I could not get a handle on this game, and I still can't.
Yeah, it has been goofy, but it has been exciting as well. You know, a lot of big plays, a lot of interceptions, a lot of long returns. So there's not been a lack of excitement, just a little strange.
It has been a half of big plays. There's no question about that, with four interceptions in the first half, thrown by Zach McCabe and two by James Vandenberg. And James Vandenberg had thrown, 348 passes, four picks. He gets two in the first half. We need to thank some sponsors here.
It's been a crazy first half. Mid-American Energy, obsessively, relentlessly at your service. Your neighborhood Applebee's restaurant, eating good in the neighborhood. We do want to thank Applebee's. Bank Iowa, your success, our priority. Bank Iowa. And we also want to thank Casey's General Store. We'll be naming the Casey's outstanding player of the game immediately following this 3A contest.
We have a leading contender,
yeah,
by
we
the
do.
Way.
We do. Hey, we also want to remind everyone, www.ihssn.com. That is the website, the schedule of all the championship broadcasts right there on the Iowa High School Sports Network website, www.ihssn.com. You can also go there, and that's where you can get your championship DVDs.
I want to remind everybody, visit that website, because you do get the schedule, and then if any one of your sons or daughters or neighbors or whoever is competing and you can't make it, you can see the action right there on that website. I mean, year-round, we're talking wrestling, basketball, baseball, whatever. It's there, and it's a great thing to let grandma, grandpa know about if they live somewhere far away.
It is, and around the world. You can go there wherever you are, and you can tune in and check out the high school championships. Don't forget, at the end of the Iowa High School Football Championships, Mid-American Energy will be presenting the MVP Outstanding Player Award, along with a $1,000 college scholarship. Mid-American Energy, a proud supporter of Iowa High School Athletics, obsessively, relentlessly, at your service, Mid-American Energy. And here come the teams. Sioux City Heelan out of their locker room. And there are the Chiefs of Keokuk.
Very impressed with the Sioux City Heelan offense that first half. Weger really ran hard. I mean, he did a great job. You know, he's got that bad ankle, and yet he's still out there turning that ball upfield and really, you know, busting a hump. I'm impressed by him.
And again, we talk about the fact that last year Bishop Heelan started eight sophomores. They'll have their entire offensive line back next year. All of those guys are juniors. I mean, this Bishop Heelan team, they are really developing into a fine 3A program. And again, for the Chiefs, Keokuk Chiefs, it's the first time they've been in a Class 3A state championship game. This is a big opportunity for these student athletes. We do want to thank some sponsors for helping us make this broadcast possible on the Iowa High School Sports Network. Wellmark Blue Cross Blue Shield, you just can't beat the Blues. Also want to thank the University of Northern Iowa. And we want to thank Russell Athletic Wear. Nice. big thanks to Cookies, Sauces, and Seasonings. Thank you very much to Cookies for being a sponsor of the Iowa High School Sports Network. 21-7, that's the score right now.
I do want to mention one thing about Heelan. You know, for many years, Heelan was the gold standard in 4A. They've won 4A state championships. They were the best 4A team in Western Iowa year in and year out. Now they've dropped to 3A, and when you beat Harlan, because Harlan's the gold standard in 3A and have been that way, it seems like, forever.
Yep.
When you beat them, you have achieved the gold standard level in Class 3A. So kind of unique that they have been a gold standard at 4A and now at 3A.
And we talk about Heelan being such a young team. Keokuk, on the other hand, is pretty much all seniors. This class, they're playing their state championship game, the first state championship game in the history of their school, and looking to go out on a real strong note.
21-7, that's the score right now. We'll take a look at the student section there of Keokuk, trying to root on their Chiefs.
Keep going. There she is. There she is. That's the girl right there that looks like Jack's prom date back at Cornell High School.
Wonder what happened to her.
That takes a lot of time to prepare.
I like it.
That takes a long time to prepare.
That's a good look. 45 is the number.
Well, it will be Keokuk football, I believe, gentlemen, to start the third quarter.
Chris Hopkins wears 45 for Keokuk.
Down to the sidelines, Travis Morgan is standing by. Travis.
Guys, just got done talking with head coach Roger Jansen of Heelan, and really no surprise at what he says. They can't beat themselves. Four turnovers, three of them more or less really cost them 21 points. So, got to cut down the turnovers, and they got to sustain drives and finish. Otherwise, he feels they're pretty good. I mean, they're right in the ball game. They're not getting outplayed by any means, so this is a long way from over, he said, and his boys know it. So we'll see if they can come out in the second half and cut down the turnovers, make this thing a game.
James Hertz and Cornell Rice deep to receive.
That's a pretty dangerous duo back there.
Yeah, you ain't a
kid. I wouldn't want to be kicking the ball off too many times to Keokuk.
You ain't a kid. For help making sense of your investments, contact the Edward Jones office nearest you. Call 1-800-ED-JONES or visit edwardjones.com. And again, DVDs, championship DVDs of any of the state final games yesterday and today. You can go to www.ihssn.com and pick those up. Well, that's going to bounce at about the 2, maybe the 3-yard line. Rice is going to pick it up. He is still on his feet at the 15 before he is taken down.
Fantastic coverage by Heelan.
And more than just a couple of guys wearing blue jerseys getting off that pile.
By the way, those DVDs, great Christmas gifts.
I would agree.
Outstanding Christmas gifts.
I would agree. 21-7. Keokuk with the ball. Vandenberg will get up under center.
They're going to spread you out here. Four wides, Rice in the backfield.
James Vandenberg again has rewritten the career and single season passing marks in high school football in the state of Iowa. Pickup of 7, maybe 8 yards. Pass is going to be complete to Logan Granera.
The Heelan defense hasn't played too bad so far. Keokuk came into this game averaging 568 yards a game, and Heelan held them to 122 in the first half. So they got to be somewhat happy about that part of their game.
That's an amazing statistic, 568 yards a game.
I've been to shorter parades.
Second down and 1 at the 25. Draw play up the middle. Scat back's going to get a first down. Cornell Rice on the carry.
That's a gain of 9 for Rice. First down, Chiefs.
In on the stop for Bishop Heelan, Shea Hacker.
Excuse me, what I wanted to say was, I almost wonder in the first half whether Keokuk came out with a game plan and couldn't put it into play because they had first down at the 2 and then first down at the 10. They scored both times, but you can't establish anything. And I just wonder if maybe scoring so early kind of threw them off a little bit offensively.
Chiefs trying to spread this one out. Said this is going to be a run up the middle, a pickup of, well, they're going to carry him forward before they drive him back. A pickup of about 5. It'll be second down coming up for the Chiefs on the carry, Cornell Rice. Host of blue shirts.
Well, somebody from the back side knocked him forward about 2 yards. Trying to get on that pile, and they just knocked him forward, and Rice picks up about 6.
Sean Geary getting up off the pile. Buckley Wright there as well.
Buckley Wright hanging in there, boy. He's got a bad knee, and
he
is gutting it out.
up front defensively there for Bishop Heelan. Buckley Wright, Sean Geary, Josh Bousquet, Jake Skibinski, Joel McCabe, Chris Cavillo, Jordan Lester, and Cole Wegger. The secondary is Rickard, Wegger, and Hacker. Fires to that sideline. That pass is caught. Look out. Across midfield, the pass caught by Trevor Galbraith.
That's the first time we've seen him go to Galbraith today. They've got a lot of weapons on this offense that they can go to.
He's a good player. Now watch his pass.
That's right on the line.
I mean, that is a missile out there. Steps into it. Excellent technique. It's not just, you know, throwing the ball, but his technique is so sound where he sets off the back foot, steps directly into it. That's a good pass.
First and 10 at the 47. Vandenberg back to pass. There's the screen. Rice on his feet to the 20, to the 15, shoved out of bounds by Sean Keane.
We just talked about his arm strength, and now you see the touch.
Oh.
You know, a good quarterback not only can fire the ball in there, it took a lot of touch to get it over top of this defender here.
They're
right
going to let
Rice.
Him in, and if you'll see, Rice just sneaks out over here. They're going to let the defense come in here, and he's going to throw it right over the top over here, and it's a beautiful touch pass by Vandenberg.
That's a very tough 10-yard throw.
Right over 58. There you go. And then he gets the block downfield. He sets that block up beautifully, picks up another one from Guerrero, and that's a nice play.
You got big old linemen throwing blocks for you downfield 10 yards. That's kind of nice.
That was Jordan White downfield.
First and 10 at the 15. To the 5, pass caught by Logan Guerrero.
You know, Chuck, you talk about they haven't gotten into a rhythm yet, but this drive is exactly what they've wanted to do the whole game.
They found their stride on this drive. Just the tempo has been just right for Keokuk.
Second down and 5 after 10.
Now you got to cash in, and that's been difficult. Heelan's bent a few times, but they've hung in there. They've got to cash this in.
James Hurt, the inside receiver to the bottom of your screen, number 7. The draw play, and that's going to be close to a touchdown. It'll be first and goal to go. Cornell Rice on the carry gets to the 2.
Keokuk's been in the red zone 3 times a day, 3 touchdowns every single time. So they've done a good job of finishing drives off.
Vandenberg almost falls down after the snap. They get their feet tangled up a little bit, and somehow Rice kept his balance, but he's so low to the ground. Sometimes your center of gravity being lower gives you a little better balance. And Vandenberg almost tripped over him, but Rice had no ill effects on the run.
Cole Wegger in on the stop for the Crusaders. First and goal to go for Keokuk. Good hard running by Cole Lockwood, but nice defense there by Bishop Heelan. Second and goal to go.
One thing about good offenses, and that is they use everybody doing something they're good at. And Lockwood is an excellent runner inside the tackles. This play is designed for Cole Lockwood. And you just see, keeps his feet going, drives through. He stacked up about the 3, falls forward, almost gets it in, takes it down to the 1.
Great penetration by Sean Geary. Lockwood again. Driven back. No signal yet. It'll be third and goal to go.
That Heelan defense, they have a lot of pride. They don't want to let him in there.
Look at Cole Lockwood. The jersey's ripped. All down the side.
Third down and 1.
That's a great shot by our camera crew.
He's trying, boy. He's got those feet back, trying to grind it in there. One more time.
Josh Bousquet helping out that Crusader defense. The pitch to Rice. Speed gets him to the corner. Touchdown.
Late flag. Let's hang on here.
That was a late hit on Heelan. Rice was about 5-6 yards deep, and the Heelan guy hit him. It's going to be a personal foul on Heelan.
Jack, I think you might be right on that one, my friend. 7:38 to go. This is a passing offense, guys, but look at how much time they took off the clock. Rice gets to the corner.
Yeah, right there. Really, Joel McCabe, no need to do that. I mean, he's already in.
I like how Rice just hopped up, didn't retaliate. He's just happy to be in the end zone.
27-7. The extra point here attempted by James. Well, James Vandenberg is going to hold.
It's Guerrero.
The kick is going to be Logan Guerrero. Snap. kick. It's up. It's good. 28-7. Chiefs with the lead. 7:38 to go in the third quarter. We'll be right back in a moment.
Dodge Grand Caravan with a 5-star crash test rating. Safety is part of the family.
We'll be bringing, we'll make you happy. We stand for people, progress and pride.
Everything the Iowa Farm Bureau does, it does for Iowa. Iowa Farm Bureau supports the people and the programs that support all of us, from farmers to community leaders to our youth. Iowa Farm Bureau strives to make our state the best it can be.
There's your score, 28-7. Now the penalty on Heelan is going to be assessed at the kickoff, so the kickoff is actually going to be coming from the 45-yard line.
Great
of
chance,
Bishop Heelan.
Great chance to onside kick it if you want, right here.
Or bloop it really high and get down there and pin him deep.
With only five men up front, I'll squib it. Or kick it through the uprights. One of the
I think
other.
That's what he was trying to do, and he did it. That's a field goal.
One thing to note so far, Keokuk has tied the 3A championship game record with interceptions with four. So, and that's only in 2.5 quarters, so I wouldn't be surprised if they were able to break that record today.
Logan Granera.
Have a chance to get one more in this one.
Keokuk Chiefs, a good run. Head coach is Jason Campbell, his sixth season at the helm of Keokuk football. Roger Jansen, 26 years at his alma mater, ninth year as the head coach of the Crusaders. Bishop Heelan now trailing in this game. Wagner's going to pick up one, maybe two. Clock running at 7.5 here in the third quarter. Closed captioning for this Iowa High School State Football Championship provided courtesy of Valley Bank. Valley Bank, we lead with speed.
This is an important drive for Heelan here. If they don't put some points on the board with that offense that Keokuk has, they could be in deep trouble. So they've got to do something here.
Well, these two schools, Sioux City and Keokuk, that's about as far apart in the state of Iowa as you can get. And they're meeting here in the Unidome for a state championship.
Nice defense.
Not much running room there for Cabillo. The defense of the Chiefs responding here as they have that 3-touchdown lead.
Kyler Barnes getting down low, and Cabillo just wrapped up his feet. And, you know, he wants to bull his way forward, but when you don't have your feet, you can't do it. Nice tackle.
28-7. Even a first down here for Bishop Heelan. Well, I'm saying that just to keep the ball out of the hands of Keokuk.
They need to keep Vandenberg on the sideline.
Three wide receivers set for the Crusaders. Back to pass, fires.
Nice.
That's a nice catch. That's going to be a first down up to the 45-yard line. The catch, Zach McCabe on the pass, the catch made by Sean King.
One thing I like about McCabe is he does have his interceptions today, but he's still firing the ball in there, taking some chances. He's not letting those interceptions affect him.
Hey, 6'5", 200-pound sophomore quarterbacks don't grow on trees. I'm telling you, this kid's got some ability.
First and 10 at the 46.
With good patience, that drag route, he had to let it set up, and he did.
For the play action, McCabe back to pass. And the pass is going to be caught by Chris Cavilla.
Another good play by the Crusaders.
Out in the flats, Cavilla making the catch, pick up about eight.
Here you have your second down and short here. This is where you might want to take a chance. We talked about it earlier. Take a chance and throw a deep ball, because you still got, even if you don't complete it, you still only got third and two, third and three coming up.
Wager's getting this ball for me.
They're in that three wide receiver set. Back to pass, McCabe. Almost intercepted. Wager, you're right, Chuck. Wager was going to get the ball, but he just got all locked up with his blocker out there, and the ball was up in the air for grabs for a moment on the tip. almost came down by the Keokuk Chiefs. Over there, Kyler Barnes defending. Also over there, Brett Kelly.
I think it's 54, Sean Geary, who releases. And watch what happens. They get tangled up. There's no separation. Ball's deflected out of there and almost intercepted. But there was no relationship between the blocker and the receiver.
McCabe paid for that one there.
Third down and two at the 47. The pitch to Wager.
Not going to get it.
Just a wall of white. Cole Lockwood there defending.
On that screen pass, I want to go to one of my favorite quotes of the year. This ain't intramurals.
Brother.
Fourth and about four. Loss of a couple of on that particular play.
Boy, you're almost at the point where you're three scores down. We've got 16 minutes and 54 seconds left to play in the game. You've almost got to go for this. Power eye.
Sophomore quarterback Zach McCabe under center. Play action pass. Look out. Down he goes. Cole Lockwood coming in with the sack.
I'd like to take a look at this because when they went power eye, you're thinking run. And I think they might have too many guys in the box. And then nobody, just a swing and the miss there by Wager. And Lockwood puts a good hit on the backside of McCabe.
I'm surprised McCabe was able to hang on to that ball.
Look at hand strength.
That could have been a fumble. And there's a couple guys ready to pick it up and score there.
Paul Money was in the backfield as well, number 55.
Look out here. Look out here.
Bishop Heelan wants to take a timeout, talk about it for just a moment. 28-7, 4:34 remaining in the third quarter. We will be right back in a moment on the Iowa High School Sports Network. That's the score right now, and the ball belongs to the Chiefs of Keokuk, and they are looking to strike. Vandenberg back to pass. Over to the sideline. It's going to be caught, trying to spin away from the tackle. Logan Granera can't quite do it. That'll bring up second down and about four. Chuck, I know you've been wanting to watch this football game, and I apologize that you have to be here, but I just wanted to let you know. Late first quarter, no score between Duke and Notre Dame. No score.
Well, that big pep talk by Lou Holtz on ESPN, if that doesn't fire up the old Irish, I don't know what will.
Second and fourth to 42, and the Buckeyes beat Michigan today. Vandenberg.
Look out.
On the draw. There's some running room. There's some speed. All the way down that far sideline, Cornell Rice down to the 15-yard line, first and 10.
I like the way he finished that run, too.
Man.
Not only
hard.
He
runs
speed.
Hard.
That was Walter Payton-esque.
Not only does he have the speed, he was looking for contact at the end.
You can see once he got the corner turned, it was almost like this guy's got the speed to go. And he gets a great block right there downfield. That was number five. And that was, help me out here.
Well, right at the point of attack, Evan Isaacs, the pulling guard for Keokuk. Trevor Galbraith throwing the
downfield
block.
Block. great block, and that's what actually sprung him down the sideline, and then he finishes off the run. They're going to go slant again here.
A lot of wide receivers in that set. That's just going to be a pitch to Rice. He is driven out of bounds after a pickup of just a couple.
You know, I can't knock the Heelan defense. I think they've tried to play this straight up about as well as you can. It's just when you've got this many weapons and a team that knows how to run this offense that you don't see. I mean, it's tough.
Second down and 8 at the 13.
There's nobody on your scout team can throw the ball like him, because if they could, they wouldn't be on the scout team.
Into the end zone.
Whoa.
Out of the reach of the extended receiver, James Hurt. Now, I've got quiet there for just a moment. I wanted to watch the mechanics of James Vandenberg. He does everything right.
That one's a little off his back foot, but there was a guy right in his face, but that's still a pretty darn good throw.
Let's head down to the sidelines here for a moment. We've got Travis Morgan standing by, brought to you by Farm Bureau. Travis, what do you have, sir?
Well, guys, I'm here in, they call it Chief Nation, and I'm with the chief of the Chief Nation. This is Lindsey Nash. Lindsey, I grew up on a reservation in Walton, Nebraska. That's a pretty authentic headdress. You got papers for that?
Do I have papers?
That's what I said.
Oh, no, I don't.
Touchdown.
Cole Lockwood on the screen, touchdown. And right there, Travis Morgan in the midst of Raider Nation, Chief Nation. And they're jumping up and down. Chief Nation over there going nuts, and Travis Morgan right in the middle of it. That makes it 34-7. The extra point to be kicked here in a moment.
Just a great pass. I mean, just to draw the defenders, dump it off, great downfield blocking, and he just waltzes in.
This is a powerful offense the Keokuk Chiefs have built.
We've got a lot of candidates for player of the game from Keokuk. That's Lockwood's second touchdown. He's got an interception. Vandenberg's had a great game. Hurts had a great game. These seniors from Keokuk are really stepping up today.
Extra point up and good. 35-7, Chiefs on the Crusaders. We'll be right back in a moment on the Iowa High School Sports Network.
Hi, is there anything
I can
help you?
Hey, what's that mean? Our goal is the best network here.
Oh, well, the best network means uninterrupted service.
It's quite a goal, right?
Yes, well, for uninterrupted service, our cell tower engineers.
They sound important.
Yes, well, they really know their areas. Many of
the engineers.
Yes, they live in the area.
They live in the area, so that's smart. Smart, so smart.
Give you uninterrupted service.
Uninterrupted.
Yeah.
I like that.
U.S. Cellular is wireless where you matter most.
Because of Iowa Bankers, boys athletics in the state of Iowa continue to thrive both locally and at the state level. 9 boys sport programs, involves 80,000 students, 399 member high schools, 425 member junior high schools. Iowa Banks have been involved going on almost 2 decades, and they are strong supporters within the local school districts and each of their communities. I'm very proud of the relationship that we have with the Iowa Banks.
James Vandenberg, 15 out of 20, 204 yards, 3 touchdowns, 2 interceptions on the day. That last one, Cole Lockwood, 1 catch, 12 yards, 1 touchdown. 35-7, Chiefs with the lead. That kickoff into the end zone, 1st and 10, coming up. Travis still down there. Do we go back to the Chief Nation?
Yeah, we're back here with the Chief of Chief Nation, Lindsey Nash. Lindsey, how do you get appointed Chief of Chief Nation?
I just decided to make it, and they appointed me Chief.
What kind of decisions do you get to make in this whole thing? I mean, do you get to lead the cheers and everything then?
Yeah, I do. It's pretty fun. It's awesome.
Do you hand it down after the season's over then?
I think I should. That'd be pretty awesome.
Well, those are some tough decisions to make. Enjoying the game so far, 35-7.
Yes, it's awesome.
state champions, you think?
Yes, I think so.
All right, well, live from Chief Nation, I'm going to send it back to you guys.
Thank you very much, Travis Morgan. Travis has done a great job for us all day yesterday and into today. 35-7. Heelan with the football, trying to go deep. They will go deep all the way downfield. It's going to be picked off by Logan Granera.
That's that fifth interception, which is a championship record for Class 3A by the Keokuk Chiefs today.
That's exactly right, Jack. Class 3A, five INTs by the Keokuk defense, and that is a new. That's a new record. One I think Zach McCabe would like to have back.
Well, I mean, they're trying anything now. They're down to four scores and time's ticking away, but you can't get it all in one big chunk like that.
We do have an NAIA playoff update here. Third quarter, Morningside College leading Jamestown 38-14. Iowa Telecom Quick Stat, Sioux City, Heelan.
That's a bad number right there. That is
five turnovers in this game.
You're not going to win with five turnovers.
Vandenberg back to pass. Downfield, this is going to be picked off by the Crusaders. Bishop Heelan responding. Sean Keen picks the pass off with 3:21 to go here in this third quarter.
That's their third of the day. That's eight total. That's got to be a record, too.
Did that ball slip out of his hands or something? I mean, that was just a wounded duck. I don't know what happened to it.
Well, he kind of threw that one up for grabs.
Yeah.
There was a couple of guys I think he might have been aiming for. Cole Lockwood, James Hurt. Now, there was some pressure, obviously, being applied.
Couldn't step up into that one, that's for sure, and I think that's what caused that ball to kind of float.
First and 10 at the 28. Oh, you can hear the hitting all the way up here, folks.
Hang on to that football because they're trying to strip it out.
Brandon Wager on the carry. And he is a banged up foot. I mean, he was banged up, nicked up coming into this game. Second down and 9 coming up for Bishop Heelan.
I didn't know Travis worked for CNN. Chief Nation
Chief
Network.
Chief Nation Network, that's right. Second down and 8.
That's what happens when the game gets a little out of hand, folks.
Offset eye in the backfield, it looks like. One man coming in motion, that's Shea Hacker. Brandon on the carry, and he gets out of bounds, but that'll be a first down up to about the 42.
Nice speed that time. Exploded around the corner.
Now, Travis Morgan, our sideline reporter, has covered Bishop Heelan football, and he says you could certainly tell that Brandon Wager is a little slow. He said a couple of times that when Brandon turns the corner, if he didn't have that bad ankle, that bad leg, he'd have been gone.
Man, I wish I was a little slow.
Tight end on the near side, first and 10 at the 41 for Bishop Heelan. Wager again. Makes one man miss, makes another guy miss, makes something out of nothing, picks up 4.
Wager on the carry.
That's a good 4-yard run.
In on the stop for Keokuk, Mike Neuendorf, big old number 79.
You know, there comes a point where how much you want him to take.
Yeah. He's only a junior. He's got another year coming back.
He's hurting. He's really hurting. And he sends the guy back out. No, I'm staying in the game.
Bishop Heelan now again. This is the team that had a couple of guys competing at the All-State Music Festival earlier this morning. Once they were done there, they jumped in the van, got here in time for kickoff. So for some of these student athletes down there from Bishop Heelan, it has been quite the day. Second down and 6 at the 45. Timeout called by the Crusaders. That's their second of the half. We do want to thank Greater Des Moines Convention and Visitors Bureau, sponsor of the Iowa High School Sports Network, and your local Dodge dealer. Dodge, grab life by the horns. And by the United States Marines. Marines.com or call 1-800-MARINES. And by State Farm Insurance, your local State Farm Insurance agent. Under 2 minutes to play here in the third quarter.
You know what you better do if you want to keep him out of the game? You better go hide his helmet.
Yep.
Because he ain't going to sit over there.
Well, he's a competitor, and he wants to be in the game.
Let's take a look at the sideline here. And I think that is Roger Jansen, the head coach of Bishop Heelan, and I think he is saying, you know what? We're not going to raise the white flag, but you need a break. A lot of time left in this particular game, and Zach McCabe, that's going to be incomplete. Third down and six coming up for the Crusaders.
You know, as good as this Keokuk offense is playing, the defense has played even better. All those interceptions, just giving Heelan nothing today.
I would agree with that. Good look at Kyle Barnes there.
Can you imagine giving their offense five turnovers? Whew.
One man in the backfield for Heelan. That's a big third down. Here comes the rush. Fires it over. That pass intercepted at midfield. Zach McCabe firing the interception.
I think that's Chris Hopkins on the pick.
Chris Hopkins did come up with that interception. That's just a linebacker falling back in the hook zones.
Yep, and try to pick him up. But what happens is he rolls over here and looks downfield, and simply they get some great drop by the linebackers, and they smell it coming. There's no question. They know the ball's going over that way. And you know what? Easy pickings. Just make the catch. There you see him just dropping into the flat. Can't throw it through him.
James Vandenberg will hand the ball off. Picking up a couple of tough yards will be Cornell Rice. Cornell clock Rice. Running with 1:40 to go here in this third quarter of play.
Let me ask you a question earlier. If I'd have told you, you know, we're going to be in the third quarter and Vandenberg's going to have three picks, would you have thought it'd be a 28-point game?
No. Well, would you give me the other statistic?
That if they'd thrown six.
The other statistic? Heelan has thrown six.
Yeah, that's
the whole story. You need to tell the whole story there, Paul Harvey.
The story. You're right.
You got to tell the rest of the story. Swinging it out of the backfield, Cornell Rice. And he is going to be driven out of bounds into that Bishop Heelan bench.
That was close. I know the Keokuk people are wanting a late hit, but that was very close.
Short of the first down, it'll be third down about four.
Let's watch this and see where his feet are. That's what I always like to look at, the defender's feet when they go out of bounds. Pretty close, like I said. But heck with Rice, how many tackles has he broken today? You might as well hit him. The coach is going to yell at you if you don't.
Third down and three at the 44-yard line. And again, the give to Rice. He'll have the first down, and then some, up to about the 35-yard line. And Keokuk's just running the ball, fellas. They're not putting it up top. They're not going deep. They're running the ball.
Well, the thing is, when you spread people out, it really opens up the running game. I mean, you know, yesterday we saw Lawton Bronson with that tight double wing offense.
Yeah.
That's one way to run the football. Another way is let's spread them out and see if we can't open up some room for a very talented, shifty back to run through. And that's what Keokuk chooses to do, and they do it very well.
You know, that last play, I love Jordan White just clearing a path for that running back to tuck in behind him.
I think 35 we're going up top here. Nope.
Rice again. This time he is met, stacked up, driven back in on the stop for Bishop Heelan, Josh Bousquet. Nice stick there from his linebacker position.
And that'll do it for the third quarter. They do not have to snap the ball, and Vandenberg's over on the sideline already, so we can take a break.
35-7, that's the score right now. We got to talk. This game will be remembered for the interceptions, the turnovers, by both Zach McCabe and James Vandenberg. We've got 12 minutes left to play. 35-7, Keokuk on top of Bishop Heelan. We'll be right back. Fourth quarter coming up on the Iowa High School Sports Network. Second down and nine at the 35-yard line. Start of the fourth quarter here in this 3A championship game. Now we're going to go up top to that sideline. Is it caught? No. Out of bounds, Logan Granera. The catch was made, but he went out of bounds.
If we were in Calgary, that would be a completed pass.
Another good throw there.
Dropped it right down.
On the money.
Back there defending, Ben Rickard for...
Good coverage.
Sioux City.
I
agree.
He's out of bounds.
Step for step.
Ben Rickard's been trying, and he's had some good coverage all day. It's just, man, there's some talented guys out there for Keokuk. You're trying to make a play. They're trying to make a play. Sometimes they're going to win the battle. Sometimes you're going to win the battle.
Third down and nine. Three wide receivers putting out this formation for the Chiefs.
Whoa.
And a bad snap. This takes you out of the place of everything. And all Vandenberg's going to do is just cover up.
Which is the right play.
But you got to punt this one now. That snap, I don't know if it, I think it came early.
Let's take a look.
No, he's behind the wrong guy.
He lined up behind the guard, didn't he?
Cost him 23 yards on that.
I tell you, you don't see
James, every day. James, Mr. 3.95 grade point average. It's the guy with the football you line up behind, okay?
He knows it. He knows it. Look at him on the sidelines there. He knows it.
He's looking for a hole to climb in.
Fourth down and 32. And they're going to punt this one away, but they're first going to let some time run off the clock. The Chiefs are. Granera punts this one away. I believe that's Rickard.
Return here.
Up to about the 30-yard line, across the 35, and then a late flag comes in.
Very late flag.
Rickard on the return. And it'll be Sioux City Heelan football, and a block in the back is going to be called on the Crusaders.
Nothing going right for Bishop
Heelan. No. The hill just keeps getting higher to climb up.
We've got
Guess who's back in the game?
Number 32.
You got it.
Block in the back.
We've got our Mid-American Energy Scholarship to hand out at the end of this game. We also have our Casey's Outstanding Player Award that we will be handing out at the end of this game. Three wide receivers in this formation now for Bishop Heelan. They'll give it to number 32. Not much there.
Nothing.
Not much there at all.
Let's take a look at this one on replay. Man, just nothing. First guy comes in.
Second down, 14.
That's Lockwood. And then it's money.
Call money
in the background.
To finish up.
In the backfield.
Brandon Wager. Working hard. That's going to be a loss of four on the play. Second down and 14. Ball at the 22. 35-7. Chiefs with the lead.
I don't know if football players get purple hearts, but he may earn one today. Reverse.
Can we give our MVP award to an entire defense? Is that part of the rules?
Brett Kelly on the stop there. The carry by Shea Hacker.
That's a good call. I like the little reverse here. Lineman moving. Little ball action. I like that. But boy, I'll tell you what. They are just everywhere.
This is a really good Keokuk team.
It is.
First time that they have been into a state championship game. Everything came together for the Chiefs. Great quarterback, great defense, talented athletes.
And they haven't played a flawless game, though. I mean, they're up 35-0, and they have
35-7.
35-7. And they made their mistakes, too, so.
Triple coverage, that pass. Almost picked off by Granera.
That'll bring up fourth down and 12, so Heelan will punt this one away.
I think it's safe to say, and we've seen a lot of football, that Keokuk has the best offense in the state. I don't care if it's 1A, 3A, 12A, whatever. That is a dynamite offense.
I would agree with you. Heelan's going to punt this one away. Nice high kick. Takes a Heelan bounce down close to the 32, 33-yard line. It's going to go out at about the 30-and-a-half-yard line. And right there, that's where the Chiefs will take over.
44-yard punt.
Kyler Barnes gets away from that one, and the Chiefs will come out. take a look at the sidelines there, the Bishop Heelan student section. We do want to thank the Iowa Army National Guard, proud sponsors of the Iowa High School Sports Network and the Iowa's Abstinence Mission, IM. And Musco Lighting, we make it happen. Thanks to Musco Lighting, they've also helped us out with the Telestrator up here.
Love my Telestrator.
I know you do, and by Pizza Ranch. First and 10 at the 31 for the Chiefs. And again, just the give up the middle for Cornell Rice. Now it's just ball control and keep the clock moving right now if you're Keokuk.
I wouldn't be surprised. I kind of get the feeling the Chiefs have taken the foot off the gas pedal a little bit here. They still threw a couple passes, but I think you're going to see them run the football a lot more.
Yeah, throwing a couple passes is very conservative for them. They're usually throwing it all over the field.
Yep.
As a coach of Heelan right now, you tell these guys, remember what this feels like, because most of them are going to be back next year and hopefully back in the dome next year. So you don't want to forget this feeling. And that's going to motivate a lot of these guys all offseason.
You know, Jack Whitford, that is a great point. That is a good point to make.
Well, same thing can be said for Solon last year.
You just took the words right out of my mouth. Go. Look at Solon from last year.
You know, everybody thinks winning a state championship is a one-year deal, but sometimes it's a two-year deal where you need to get to that championship game and see how good you really are against a really good opponent. And sometimes you don't like the answer you get the first time.
Now, I don't want this to come out the wrong way, but there is something I'm disappointed about in this game. Just because the way it played out, the early turnovers, the short field for Keokuk, we have not seen this Keokuk offense at full throttle.
No.
You know, we didn't get a chance to see them.
Rice, run down by Cabello.
Cabello coming in to make the stop on Cornell Rice. He'll bring up fourth down and about five, and so the Chiefs will punt this one away.
But I still like this offense at about two-thirds throttle.
Granera to punt it away. Rickard deep to receive.
He's a good little player, Rice. I mean, he's a nice player. His football days aren't over.
There's a lot of guys on this team that you look at and say they can play at the next level.
Oh, yeah.
Hurt certainly is one of those, whether it's on defense or offense.
Lockwood.
Rickard deep to receive. That one will bounce, and he will pick it up at about the 13-yard line. Now a chance for a return. Picks
great
up one
blocks.
Block, trying to get another block, trying to get away from some of the white jerseys. Can't do it, but he brings it up across the 25 to about the 27-yard line. It'll be Crusaders football when we return. 7:06 to go in the fourth quarter on the Iowa High School Sports Network. That's the score right now inside the Unidome in this 3A championship game. I understand Western Michigan has an early lead on the Hawkeyes, 6-0. Valley Bank quick stats here in this game. Points off turnovers, Keokuk 28, Sioux City Heelan 7.
That is just monumental right there. And you know what? If you're going to turn it over to Keokuk, they are going to make you pay. I mean, that's
they've got
the
offense
play.
That can do it in a hurry.
Especially when they're only going 2 yards and ten yards.
10 yards right off the bat, exactly.
Heelan with the football.
That's Wager.
Wager up the middle, up to about the 38-yard line. That'll be a first down.
What I do like about this Heelan team is not one guy is letting up at all.
No.
The defense is playing hard still, really shutting down Keokuk on offense. They have let up a little bit, but they're playing hard. The offense is still giving it everything they got.
Well, you know, if Wager were on the sidelines, no one would think anything less of him. I mean, he over 100 yards rushing on one wheel. I mean, he gave it his all. But no, I'm back out there.
We'll send it down to Travis Morgan here in just a moment. Three wide receivers for Bishop Heelan in this set. First and 10. Wager again on the carry. Back to the line of scrimmage. And maybe a fumble on the play. And Keokuk comes up with it. Oh, my heavens, it never rains it pours. Brandon Wager, the junior running back, fumble on the play, and it'll be Chiefs football. Well, let's send it down to the sidelines very quickly to Travis Morgan. Travis?
Well, guys, moments ago, you guys were talking about players that could play at the next level on both these teams. We've seen Vandenberg, who's obviously going to go to some Division I school. We've also seen Brandon Wager, and some of you guys may not know this, but these two guys might play with each other someday, and that'd be fun because Wagger's been talking with Wisconsin, Iowa, Iowa State, KU, Missouri, Nebraska. All those schools are kind of beating on his door right now, and if Vandenberg goes to one, well, it'd be kind of nice to see those two guys on the same team, wouldn't it? Back to you.
There's the screenplay. Thank you very much, Travis. That's great insight.
I think Rice almost juked himself out there.
Well, we've got a couple of awards to hand out here at the end of the game. One, we will hand out the $1,000 scholarship courtesy of Mid-American Energy. We will also hand out the Casey's Outstanding Player of the Game. And again, that player's school will be awarded a beautiful plaque for the school's trophy case. Casey's Outstanding Player of the Game Award coming up. Casey's, a convenience store, and so much more. James Vandenberg, shotgun formation. Back to pass. Swings it to the side, and that's good defense. Just batting it away. Nice job coming up. Shea Hacker, incomplete pass. Good defense there for number 10.
If he would have caught that, there was nobody in front of him.
I'll tell you what, did anybody else hear the sound of this ball hitting his hands?
You got to read and react. You got to read and react. Halftime score, guys, NAIA playoffs. St. Xavier over St. Ambrose, 14-6. We're at half.
You got 30 minutes to go, Coach.
I tell you, Fighting Bees are a second-half team. Morningside
I would expect
in the fourth,
you to say nothing different.
Morningside leading their NAIA playoff game, 38-14 in the fourth quarter. Rice bounces to the outside. And that's going to be a first down inside the 30-yard line.
How about Vandenberg running down there looking to throw a block? Now, he didn't throw one, but still, watch number 10 on the effort. You'll see him at the top of your screen. There he is. Gave it a look at least.
In the semifinal win, he was throwing some blocks on some of those.
Hey, he's 6'3", 190 pounds. It's not like he's some flower out there. I mean, he takes some licks.
It's got to be rewarding for these Keokuk seniors. They played together a long time and worked extremely hard to get to this point. So this has got to feel good the last 5 minutes of this game.
5:10 to play. Cornell Rice has some running room. Rice, touchdown. 29-yard touchdown run for Cornell Rice. 5:07 to go in the ballgame.
Just too much speed, man. I mean, he turns on the jets here, and he gets that corner. Look out. You know, a couple guys have angles on him, and he just runs away from them.
Logan Granera, great downfield blocking by that chief wide receiver. Cornell Rice with the run.
Usually when you see a long run like that, there's a receiver blocking hard down the field, and Granera had a nice block on that run.
Extra point attempt here by Granera.
Cornell Rice making a late run for our Player of the Game Award.
Kick is up, and it's good. 42-7 now in favor of the Keokuk Chiefs. First time the Chiefs have been in a 3A championship game. They're in a position to take home the whole thing.
Trucks and truck drivers deliver the goods that make our world go round. As the largest private flatbed company in the nation, TMC is proud to do its part. At TMC, conduct counts, and that is why we are proud to be the founding sponsor of Conduct Counts. Conduct Counts reaches out to parents and students to ensure that high school activities are fun for everyone. It embodies a philosophy and a lifestyle that have long been a staple of our company. At TMC, conduct counts.
There's a young man who just scored the last touchdown, Cornell Rice, leading the Chiefs here. Two touchdowns today, 16 carries, 103 yards. Pretty good day's work. 42-7 now. The Chiefs, now they've set themselves up. They're going to win their first state football championship.
Should mention here that with the 35-point difference, we're going to have rolling clock here in the final 5:07.
There's their quarterback. Does he taking a knee on the sideline, James Vandenberg.
Does he know they're up 35? He looked angry.
That ball rolls through the end zone. It'll be first and 10 at the 20. Nebraska offered him this week on his wristband. He's got a Tiger Hawk.
Michigan State.
Talking to him.
Kansas, Missouri. One nice thing that his parents can pretty much put in the bank is they're not going to have to pay for his college education. And that's a nice thing.
That's very true.
You know, with a competitor like him, you know, they're up 42-7, but there's a couple throws he wants to take
back. Yeah.
He hasn't played his best game of the year by any means. And when you're a competitor like that, that still haunts you a little bit.
What would you say, about a C? I'd give him about a C. It was about an average game for him.
Yeah.
And that's pretty good average.
Under five to play here in this fourth quarter. And we do have a final, and we've kept you up to date on this Morningside College playoff game. Sioux City, Morningside College, Bishop Heelan, Sioux City, 45-14, the final. Morningside winning and advancing in the NAIA football playoffs.
They're beginning to be a staple in the NAIA playoffs,
yeah,
Morningside College.
Between Morningside and Northwestern and St. Ambrose, good football at that level. Second down and nine. When would we like to announce the Casey's outstanding player of the game? Now you got some guys being substituted in and out for both Keokuk and Bishop Heelan.
Generally, the offense determines when the reserves come in. The team trailing, if they still have their starters in on offense, you can keep the starters in on defense. And Heelan's brought in some reserves, but yet still some starters out there.
Zach McCabe under center, rolling out. Fires to the sideline. The pass is going to be in and out of the hands of the intended receiver, Chase Weaver.
Good throw. Hit him right in the four.
Just one of those days for Heelan.
Yep.
Well, Bishop Heelan, they've got a pretty good athletic program up there. Basketball state finals, baseball semifinals this past year. Boys state track, they had an outstanding season there. And when you take a look at Zach McCabe, we've talked so much about James Vandenberg. For that young man, Zach McCabe, he's already got a couple of Division I programs looking at him.
Tremendous basketball player.
Yep.
And he's only a sophomore.
Right.
Yep, that's what the programs are looking at him for, is basketball.
Yeah. Heelan has two Division I prospects on the basketball floor.
Heelan punts it away. It'll be first and 10 for the Chiefs. 42-7 the score. The clock continues to run. We're in that rolling clock situation.
Now you see the future of Keokuk football coming out on the field as they start to rotate some players in.
James Vandenberg, though, still coming out to be the signal caller. With 2:35 to go in the ballgame.
Well, basically,
he may run one play and then they'll take him out.
Yeah, I think they're just putting him in there so he can come out and receive the ovation, the well-deserved ovation from the Keokuk fans.
They'll wait
and he's
they
just going to hand it off. I mean, this isn't going to be anything fancy.
And the handoff to Rice.
Rice tackled for short game.
And that's
there he
it.
Goes. I think that's going.
Or is he going over to get the play?
He's going over to get the play.
Well, that's got to be a pretty happy coach over there, that entire coaching staff. Jason Campbell, Doug Dodds, Chad Campbell, Ryan Bliss. The coaching staff for the Keokuk Chiefs. Chiefs will go home class 3A state champs. Turnovers early. Turnovers early, and Keokuk put it in. It was 14-0 simply off turnovers of Bishop Heelan before, you know, we really settled in.
And Heelan with 7 turnovers. I don't care who you are, if you have 7 turnovers,
that's tough to overcome.
You're not going to lie.
No shot.
Well, let's go ahead and name our Casey's outstanding player of the game.
And the reason we voted for this guy was because when the game was on the line, he was really big.
That's right. Now, this is going to be it. With 1:22 to go, they are starting to move in some of the reserves there for.
And there goes our Casey's player of the game right
now, right.
James Hurt. Outstanding player of the game for the 3A football game, awarded by Casey's. Two interceptions, two touchdowns, all when the game was on the line. He was really the difference in this game when it mattered.
Played good defense and had some fantastic catches. Third down and three at the 49. And again on the carry, Cornell Rice. Close to a first down.
It's all academic. They've got to snap it one more time. So clock keeps rolling. Congratulations to the Chiefs.
You bet. And Vandenberg's going to finish the ride. Seconds to go here in this football game, 42-7. It's a good shot of Chief Nation there, the student section. One more snap for the Keokuk Chiefs.
Oh, they just got the coach
with
the water bucket.
They just got the coach with the Gatorade. We just saw that. Vandenberg's going to take a knee, and it's all over.
Gutty effort by the Crusaders. I mean, they laid it all on the line. They tried.
Well, there's great football tradition at Bishop Heelan in Sioux City. 4A, now 3A. For the Keokuk Chiefs, this is their first championship game. First championship game of any kind. Bishop Heelan, they've been to the Dome a couple times. But right now, this is Keokuk's day. Their first championship game, their first 3A football championship. Congratulations to the Keokuk Chiefs.
It does for Iowa. We support farmers and agriculture, helping them build their businesses and our state. We fund rural and community development, creating opportunities in Iowa towns, small and large. We encourage a healthy Iowa lifestyle with health and wellness programs that benefit everyone. And we focus on our youth and their education, making sure the future of Iowa gets the best start possible. At Iowa Farm Bureau, we promote the people, progress, and pride that is Iowa. Become a member and help us make our state the best it can be.
People, progress, and pride is true. Iowa Farm Bureau, helping you.
Well, back in 1975 and 1982, Sioux City Heelan won the Class 4A State Football Championship. This year, Keokuk winning their first ever state football championship. The Class 3A champs, the Chiefs of Keokuk. Let's go down to Mr. Bud Legg down on the turf. He is handing out the awards courtesy of the Iowa High School Athletic Association.
And we hope there'll be lasting memories of what it means to play in an Iowa State Championship. To present the trophy medals and banners to the participating teams and cheerleaders, members of the Board of Control of the IHSAA, Mr. Brett Nanning, chairperson from superintendent at schools at Tri-Center Neola, Carol Greta, representing the Department of Ed, Deb Menke, the principal of Pleasant Valley, and Fred Whipple, the superintendent of schools at Mediapolis. Crusaders, I'm going to tell you one thing. It's been a great year. You may not think about it right now, but it's been a great season. You won your district. You put together a great winning streak to arrive here for the 27th time. And you brought the Crusaders to the state championship game for the first time in 15 years. That's an awful lot to be proud of. We congratulate the Crusaders of Bishop Heelan Catholic. Chiefs, you're a history-making team. First time in the state championship and your first ever state championship trophy. We salute the Keokuk Chiefs.
Nobody does it better, Bud Lake from the Iowa High School Athletic Association, handing out the awards. 42-7 the final. The Chiefs, your 3A state champs.
The fastest way to end the fun. Get the facts. Be responsible. Teen pregnancy, it's for real.
Well, that's it, Mom. I hope it all fits in my dorm room.
And to my wife for 20 wonderful years.
Why don't you do the charity walkathon with me, Mom? No matter how things change, Wellmark Blue Cross and Blue Shield is there, giving you a number of ways to take charge of your health so you can meet life's events with confidence, like more plans to fit your needs now and in the future, along with hassle-free service. Wellmark Blue Cross and Blue Shield. The difference is blue.
Because of Iowa Bankers, boys athletics in the state of Iowa continue to thrive both locally and at the state level. 9 boys sport programs, involves 80,000 students, 399 member high schools, 425 member junior high schools. Iowa Banks have been involved going on almost 2 decades, and they are strong supporters within the local school districts and each of their communities. I'm very proud of the relationship that we have with the Iowa Banks.
Keokuk Chiefs, your Class 3A state champs, 42-7 the final. Mid-American Energy is proud to present number 15, Jake Waters, the quarterback of Council Bluffs St. Albert, with the MVP Outstanding Player Award, and along with that, a $1,000 college scholarship. So thank you very much to Mid-American Energy, Jake Waters, and Council Bluffs St. Albert, your Class 1A state champs. That game was yesterday afternoon. Jake had a sensational game, 12 out of 18, 139 yards, and 1 touchdown. When we come back, we will have our Casey's Outstanding Player of the Game interview, James Hurt from Keokuk, when we return.